You are now listening to The Dignified Delinquent. Hey, it's just sophisticated ignorance at its best.
My name is Vanessa, and I ask tough questions.
Hey, it's Gold. You know we stay lit, and you know why you're here. So let's get it.
Yep, it's your boy Jerry the Great, and you are tuned into a brand new episode of the Dignified Delinquents Podcast. And as always, I got my people in the building. First and foremost, that dude Vasco, what they know?
Hey man, say it with me, bro. You ready? One, two, three. Yo, what it is, what it do, man? It's your boy Sco, aka I am .VSJ, aka Head Honcho of Hype, aka the best vlogger and
lover.
You know, man. Welcome back.
When you said what you were, you talking to us or to them?
I was talking to them.
Okay.
I didn't mean to catch y'all off guard. Yeah. No, it was just a no. I know y'all like saying it with me.
I wonder if anybody really said it with you.
Hey, let me know.
Said it, let them know.
Put it in the
let
comments.
Let me know. You feel me? Hey, to the right, man. I got the one and the only Nessa. Nessa, how you doing?
I'm good.
I'm great.
Get it in.
I got here late.
Hey.
I'm finna put on my skates.
Yeah.
And then I'm going on a date.
Yeah.
With my mate.
Yeah.
That's more times than I ever went.
Then I'm eating off his plate.
Cheese.
Sound like that little thing you wrote on your school paper.
That you took home and folded up.
Rats.
No, Vanessa wrote something about you. I guess you was teaching there versus there. And
yeah,
there.
We did there, and there.
And what was the example that you used for the kids?
Young and Ace and Fulio need to squash their beef. Which spell the right there.
I was thinking it was only T-H. That's possessive, though.
Yeah,
T-H-E-I-R. That one, or however you spell
E-I-R.
It.
E-I-R, mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, very good, very good.
What do people confuse that with oftentimes? Why do people confuse those?
I think everybody just defaults to T-H-E-R-E.
And what's that one? That's like
that's
over that.
Location.
Over
location. And then the other one is they are.
T-H-E-Y apostrophe R-E.
Mm-hmm.
They are.
We've and been then, doing homophones all week.
Is that what that is, homophone?
Pretty sure.
What's another homophone? I don't know.
Shoot and shoot. The laundry shoot versus shoot you.
Win and win?
Yeah. Okay. Hour and hour.
Okay. Yep. I've been at school for a minute, but I know a little something.
They were like, this is easy. Until so they started going through it, and we started going over it, and they was like, dang.
I got that one too.
Dang.
It was difficult. It was more challenging than I thought it was.
Don't meet a grown person sliding to somebody DMs and you don't know the difference between the words because it ain't cute.
Have you ever had that happen to you? Like somebody was like, hey.
Yes, not that often though, because people usually know I'm a teacher.
Okay.
So they come right.
That's fucked with me. I ain't gonna lie to you.
What's that?
As a communication major, like when I talk to people on text, even if it is text, I kind of like people to use the right grammar. Is it irks me? Is this like a. Why would you not say the right words?
Do you prefer people to type out thank you or can they say tie?
Oh, you can say tie. It's okay. Well, depending on what I done did for you.
My niece did that to me one time. My niece, Khalees. It was her birthday, so I texted. I was like, hey, happy birthday. She said T-Y. I said, you better type it out.
With a heart emoji.
And she was like, sorry, uncle. Thank you. I was like, yeah, nigga.
The only one you can't abbreviate is HBD.
Happy birthday?
Don't do that to me. You could say that.
Can you say good morning? Can you abbreviate GM?
You could GM me.
Don't GM me.
People be busy.
Don't GM me. You can say it to your phone. Good morning. You can say
hey,
that.
Hey Siri.
Hey,
saying good morning.
Or just hit the little button and it's like,
hey, not for real.
Yeah. You seriously have your ass fucked up.
Hey, look.
That, relax. The fuck is you texting good morning?
At fucking 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock at night. Who the hell is
not
this?
Not a bitch in Hawaii. The time difference.
How you doing though, Skull, man?
I'm chilling, man. Can't complain. You know what I'm saying? A little soul.
From what?
I'm a little soul. I had, so yesterday there was a flag football event like at the school and my homie, my roommate Khalil, he's in it. He was like, hey man, we finna slide out. Do you want to come? I'm like, not really. Like, I want to kind of get home from work and chill.
Yeah.
But it was his first day back. Since he was like had like this whole week with his girlfriend because it was her birthday.
Oh, he took on vacation?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Oh. Type shit. So I was like, all right, you know what, bro? I'm like, shit, I ain't see my dog in a minute. I got to go chill with him. So I'm like, all right.
Oh, you live with?
Yeah.
That's love.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm like, I slide out to the game because I haven't caught a game as well and to be playing for a minute. And I got other homeboys that's on the team too. So I'm like, all right, cool, I'm going to show up. So I brought my cleats just in case.
He probably walked up in his cleats.
Y'all know him. I brought him just in case somebody needed me.
Pulled up to the scene. Cole, you playing? Nah, I ain't playing after I pulled the cleats out. Start throwing the gloves on. Nah, I ain't playing. Y'all got some extra flags around here. So we start playing, bro. But like, it was cool when I was out there. But as soon as I got back home, oh yeah, I was like, okay, I feel a little bit.
You ain't been working since you, not working, but you ain't been working out and stuff since.
No, I've been working out. It's but that was the difference when I was stretching them ligaments and hitting real hard and stopping it. I was like, sheesh.
Yeah.
It felt good when I was out there, but then this morning I woke up like, ooh, damn.
What were you saying that happened that between two friends or something? Right. What happened?
So yeah, I wanted to ask y'all this on the podcast, see if anybody can give me some insight. So check this, man. I got two homies. It was playing on two sides of the ball, two different teams. Mm. All right.
I know what that means.
Right. Huh?
You don't gotta.
No. I'm saying, for the other people who don't know, one is on the rival team.
This I know one what that means.
On our team. So I get to talk to him like, bro, why did you come over here? He was like, nah, bro, they were just too good. We were trying to even out the teams and shit. Say less. I understand a fair game. Hopped over there. However, during us playing, it started getting a little friction. It's football. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? This ain't nothing new to us. We used to this. However, the stuff that we was used to hearing when we was on the team, mm-hmm. we heard that for about the first 30 minutes. After that, shit started getting a little deep.
Mm.
What's normal stuff?
Normal stuff is like, nigga, you trash. Like, you can't guard me. You sorry. Okay. Put money on it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's stuff like that. No, then you got other stuff.
Mm-hmm. What's the other stuff?
Other stuff get
pussy
a little
ass nigga.
Bitch ass nigga. Yeah, that can get a little personal.
Oh, soft ass nigga.
Depending on
what
how you deliver it.
Doing at home, stuff like that. They ask about your girl and stuff like that.
Nah, they just start bringing up old shit about like, this the reason why you weren't playing. Oh,
mm.
You know what I'm saying? When we she did.
Oh, bitch, you know, riding ass.
You was my fucking backup. I'm on the field. I'm like, bro, like. I'm like, we homies. But at the end of the night, though, G said we was all cool. However, I wanted to, that brought up the question to me.
Well, who won? Tell me who won.
We won.
No, which person won? Like, who said, that's why you used to be my backup, did that team win?
No.
Oh, damn.
No.
Okay, well.
Yeah. So, and then, like, it got worse after the game, because, you know what I'm saying, you always feeling salty. Mm-hmm. You just lost, and you was talking shit. It's not a good feeling.
Yeah.
So, I'm like, all right, this is understandable.
It was cheating.
No, we ain't cheat.
Last question. Okay. Was there like, is there prizes involved if you win trophies or anything?
To be honest with you, I had to ask Lil. Okay. I didn't know. I was just going out to just have a good time.
Okay, find out for me.
For sure.
The level of intensity to reward. I'm just curious.
When you think about the characters that are surrounded by each other though at that point in time, you already know some bullshit going on. So I'm in the back. I'm like, damn. And then it made me think of the question. Is, when it comes to friends, if you talk shit with your friends, when it comes to your friends, is there a level of going too far? Because I can sit and I can hee-hee and I can joke with you all day and I can say this and you can say this to me, but I know we homeboys at the end of the day, so none of that shit really matter. That's like my damn brother saying something. I don't really hear it. It don't really faze me. However, when it does get to the point where it's a little deeper.
I don't know. I'm sensitive.
Are you?
I think I am, yeah. I don't take stuff, especially if I feel like I really tried at something, mm-hmm. or if I feel like I tried to treat you well, like if somebody would call me selfish, like I would, like maybe I am, but fuck, I'm trying really hard not to be. Like
acknowledge
and then,
that.
Yeah. So there's, but I with that said, there's only certain people in my life that can get me like that.
True,
like unless you like, you know, on this top five, then you could say anything and I'm be like, okay, fuck you. But those five, they say something like, you're being mean, Vanessa. I'm like,
it'd be your closest people that really like drive it home for
that,
you.
That's for me.
What do you do when they say that? You start crying?
No, I'll shut down.
Mm.
Really?
I might cry. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm the type that'd be like, okay. And I won't talk for a while.
I gotta let you know.
I gotta think about it for a while. Mm. I gotta sit on stuff.
I have my moments where it's like I can control how I'm really feeling, like emotional wise, and I can articulate what I really want to say in a positive way versus, oh, I'm pissed.
Mm-hmm.
I don't give a fuck. How this come out, what come out, you just finna know.
I almost never reach that
this
level.
This is how I feel.
How long does it take you to get to that level?
It literally take, like, it really is like a three-step process for me. Two steps. One time, I'm gonna tell you, bro, like, don't say that again. That kind of hurt. Second time, I'd have told you one time already. Don't say that. cause that shit really hurt.
Yeah.
Third time, now we just finna be going back and forth. I ain't finna put my hands on you now like that. You my boy, but just know I'm finna start saying hurtful shit back. Cause you my, if you my best friend or you my friend, I know something. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you gonna dig?
Hell yeah! Cause okay. I only cause I feel like you digging at me.
Okay.
After I just told you twice respectfully, like please stop. So now you
can. Nah, gotta get disrespectful.
You can dish it out, but just don't feel no type of fucking way when I start hurting that feeling back.
Mm-hmm. I don't got that skill. What, I always like to cuss somebody, slap the fuck out. I don't think feel like I've ever really, really done that. And I feel like there's some people that's been doing that since like the fifth grade. And they're like experts at it. Oh, yeah. And me, I'll like stumble over my words and all that. I got to really think about what I have to say, plan it out. And then the conversation never goes the way I think it's going
to
go.
Oh, no. Nah, because they say other shit that you wouldn't even prepare
so I don't
for.
Even try to get hype and stuff. I'll just be like, all right, don't chill.
Relax the whole time.
Don't say nothing else.
Yeah. I don't think I got words. Like, I don't, I'm sure words hurt everybody, but I'm more so like, if the moment I feel you coming at me, I'll have to bite my tongue a lot because I know I can say some shit that'll break some people down like a fraction.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to, I bite my tongue often. So so for me, I don't really get the words ain't gonna hurt me because I'm gonna hurt you before you hurt me with the words. Like it's, I'm gonna have your feelings hurt. You might not show it when you, like Vanessa said, you might not show it in front of me, but when you get in that car, you can be like, yeah, damn, that nigga hit me with that.
Speaking and going to your, back to your point about how people was doing this since they was young, did you start this? Like, did you start that, developing that habit when you was young, being able to get back at people like that?
I don't think, I don't got to get back. Like, I don't snap back at you. Like, it's not like that.
Yeah.
But mine is like, you say something to me, I'm going to say something back to you, dumbass.
Okay.
Like that.
Okay.
And like, so like, not necessarily to you, dumbass, but like.
But no. But
like,
yeah.
So like, we was in the group, right? We was in the group chat. Like, this is a family group chat too.
Okay.
And this was, I you shoot at me. I gotta shoot back.
It's just how it works.
So there was a big group picture of me, of us, like a family.
And it was
not of me, of me. It was a big group picture of me. But in this group picture, I looked unpleasant. I didn't look the best. Like it was a terrible angle. I hated this picture.
Okay.
Like I'm big, but like I ain't that damn big. Okay. Like I don't know who took this picture, what their camera was on, right? Mm. So somebody put the group that picture in the chat. And was like, look at Jeriel.
Oh.
Then somebody else came back and like, no, you screenshot it.
No, they didn't.
And they put it on me like, look at
it. Zoomed it up.
So the first thing I said to us, because we was getting ready for a picnic, the first thing I said to a group, I was like, hey, all right now. that's my warning shot.
This is hey.
That's my warning shot.
One time.
I think somebody else said something. I laughed too hard in the group. So I felt they laughed too hard in the group. I said, I know motherfuckers ain't in here talking about me. Ain't nobody in this bitch got ankles. Ain't nobody in this bitch got a neck. So what
Jerry!
We got on you? So I gotta get you off me like that. But I wasn't gonna say nothing. I was gonna let it slide. My sister was like, "You better say son shit. Say
gotta,
son.
Gotta get
it." And
up.
I was like, "It ain't worth." But then I was like, "If you planning this whole goddamn menu, I ain't see a salad on this bitch." All right. Can't none of us run up and down a goddamn flight of stairs. So what I suggest we do is shut the fuck up and finish planning this damn food.
Oh,
they zoomed in on you.
That part.
Mm-hmm.
I would have loved
vertical.
Why would you have loved that, Vanessa?
See that? No, because me and my siblings, we don't fight like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like I guess we all sensitive. We all like after that first shot, like damn.
Why would you do that?
Fuck it, I'm out the chat.
Invite her back.
I'm gone.
I invite her back.
Yeah, fuck that. Yeah, give me like 3 weeks and I'll be back.
Damn, bro. Well, hey man, y'all let me know down in the comments, bro, because I really did ponder on this. Is there taking that friendship talking shit to another level, yay or nay? Y'all let me know, man.
Yeah. Hey, Vanessa, is homecoming for a lot of schools right now?
It is.
I guess October is a big homecoming month. So middle schools do homecoming. Some of them do.
We trying to put together like a spirit week.
Okay.
So they can still do something, but homecoming invites outsiders to the school.
Does it?
Yeah,
it's home,
you get the dates
coming.
I guess.
So for high school, a lot of times, well, maybe not here, but yeah, some schools like Reigns and Rebaugh here, their homecoming is very big.
Yeah, that's true.
So schools with a big culture definitely do it in high school, but middle school, no, they don't do it.
You get a little 8th grade dance.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Get the hell
now, I've been seeing. I saw one. My wife was showing me there was a 90s week at this school, and like they were like. They weren't really. Was it 90s or was it 2000s?
They said
90s, but it was giving 2000s. Very 2000s vibe
on the TikTok.
Yeah, no, it was
Gauchos.
It was on the north side of Jacksonville, First Coast High School.
Okay.
So, and then, like, I remember back in the day, but like, before I was in school, they used to do opposite day, like, where boys dress as girls and girls dress. So, what are some things that you see in school or the new norms? What do you think?
One of my colleagues, she has a nephew, and he goes to school in high school in Orange Park, and the students wanted to do a gender bender day.
What's that?
That's basically opposite day. Okay, yeah. Okay. So like when we were in high school, that was a thing, and the girls came dressed like guys, and even football players participated and dressed like girls. But now it's like absolutely not. Don't even think about it. So the kids thought that they were gonna do it anyways, like go rogue. Bro. So the boy came to school, I guess, in a dress, and it was like all hell. But in my mind, because the parent was all upset, and I was like, well,
the parent was upset because of.
See, I didn't know that the kids just went rogue. I thought it was planned. The kid did it even though the parent didn't want them to do it. I'm like, pick and choose your battle. So what he wants to, you know what I'm saying? Was the dress full length? Was he all the way covered? Was it your dress code? Then what you mad for? But then when she told me that it wasn't on the scheduled list of events, that the kids just, since they said we're not going to do it, we're doing it.
We're going to do it anyway.
Yeah.
Fuck them.
Yeah. So then she was mad. The gender bender day or the opposites, ain't no more of that.
Man, you know it was lit.
What?
That powder puff.
Powder puff football. Yeah, I used powder to coach was that. Lit. Yeah, I was just finna say that.
Man, hey, shout out to my powder puff team back in the G, boy. We was undefeated. He does all that.
That's when you got the girls, right? You coach the girls. Yeah, yeah.
Try to coach them up on the game.
That was safety.
I can see you being a safety.
You play flag football for the season?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice.
In high school. Nice. But once I was on the softball field, and I'm like, trying to brag too much,
hey.
But it was especially when I got to high school. It was like, yeah, you come over here, you can play flag real quick and just make it to softball games. Like, hey, come here, you can play basketball.
I coached flag football in high school, so I was in high school, and my brother was a coach. Coach Gambone was a coach, and I came on as an assistant coach because I didn't have no classes. But that's what we did. Like, hey, track girl, hey. Track season finna be over. You fast. You ain't gotta come early. Just shit. Come on.
You kinda tall. Yeah. Come on.
All we need you to do is stand right there and run. Oh, you found them. All we need you to do is stand right there and just run.
I
just got an alert that President Bill Clinton has been admitted to the hospital with an infection, and the irony of that. I don't know what kind of infection, but it's Clinton, so I couldn't read the story. Have y'all been watching the impeachment? The American Crime Story impeachment?
Mm-mm. No. I was going to say, what? FX. That's still going?
On FX, American Crime impeachment. So it's basically like the Monica Lewinsky, Bill Clinton, Linda Tripp story.
Oh, I would be interested.
It's good.
Yeah.
I think it's on Hulu. I think it comes on Hulu next day.
I was going to say, I don't watch nothing unless it come on.
So this is a series?
Amazon, Netflix.
Hulu. They made a whole series about this man getting his dick sucked.
More so the impeachment and leading up to it. But did y'all watch the OJ one? American Crime Series
OJ? I did watch the OJ one.
So it's the same
people.
Is that
one with Cuba?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I seen that.
So it's that same series.
He played
that role. You know who did better in that? Johnny Cochran?
Yeah, Vince. He was good, too.
He did.
I didn't know to love him or hate him in that show.
Who, Johnny Cochran?
Yeah.
I loved him.
I loved him, too. But I was like,
especially
damn.
When he said,
but still.
Nigga, please. When he said that. I was like, oh, that's my
the
dog.
The last little dialogue at the end between him and the other lawyer.
Him and Richard Shapiro?
Mm-hmm. I was like, okay.
I ain't gonna lie to you, though. After watching that, I definitely, like, he did that shit.
Oh, he definitely
You think
did.
OJ did it?
Oh, hell, he did that shit.
I think OJ know who did it. I don't think that he did it himself personally. Nah. I think maybe his son could have did it.
I knew off that damn phone call that they had when they was calling him to say, hey, yo, your wife is dead. He was, oh, my God.
I think that he knew.
Hey, we... What? I'll be right down there.
But I think his son, he had a son do it, and then like, okay, I'm gonna cover up for my son. That's what I think.
I don't know, but he definitely. I think he did that junk because the whole part about him not even asking what happened to her.
Come on.
That was a little much.
Sus. Mm-hmm. And then these the temper tantrums that he was throwing just out of nowhere, even from losing damn chess or whatever in the rooms. I was like, bro, you need to. You don't look good right
Relax.
Now.
Johnny Cochran was the one that bitch. If people wasn't cheering for OJ, they was cheering for Johnny Cochran.
Mm.
If someone did that to you, you would say that they were racist, wouldn't you? Yeah, they would. Yeah, sure enough, Johnny. Now, if the glove don't fit,
you must
acquit. That's one of the best lines in judicial history.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he definitely played that.
If the glove don't fit,
John Travolta was getting on my nerves in that movie.
Who was he? Shapiro.
Yeah,
Shapiro.
He was like a little hoe.
What?
was, bro. You was switching sides, man. You need to stand on that shit. He was on this side 1 second, then you flipped over here because you wanted to protect your interest, and then you hopped back on this side. Nigga, you better. I'm fighting for my life.
Yeah. Hey, hey, hey. We ain't finna settle nothing. Nah. What'd you?
I thought we was finna go to the R. Kelly.
Oh, that's what you want to go to?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I was gonna move to Issa. Then no, this is because we're talking about TV shows. So Issa Rae was in the news lately. She said that when she first started making her shows, Awkward Black Girl was like her first YouTube series. Awkward Black Girl, and it's still on YouTube too. She said that someone gave her advice and said that you have to cast a white person in this. I'm paraphrasing, to make people care about your show. And Issa was like, she was planning to have like an all black show. They're like, no, you need a white person to make people care. So she said she casted a white person, Awkward Black Girl, and then she did the same thing with Insecure when she hired Frida. And now she's like, she's out of that mold, and now she's just doing black. You think that was bad advice, good advice, crazy advice?
Seemed like good advice. Seemed like it worked and got her. I'm not saying that she wouldn't have got where she is, you know, without that role. Is that the nonprofit?
That's girl? Yeah, that Frida, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And we got y'all.
Yeah, it sucks that that's the way it is, but unfortunately that's just the way it is. I was just thinking about they just named Jacksonville a supernova city because it is about
what's a supernova? Oh, like something
that's about to blow up, and it's brilliant and beautiful and all of this stuff. And I'm like, dang, that's so cool. Except for
what else there?
Where I work, I don't see nothing like that. And on our neighborhoods, we don't have nothing but Walmart and Taco Bell's. So it's like, but if we had different demographic, you know, maybe it would be different. So I think it's very true.
Yeah.
Hey, man, look. And that industry is very tough to be successful. And sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. So this advice, while like I can understand her being hesitant on it because she had this idea of I just want an all black cast to be able to launch with my messages and show all these people what I have up here. Yeah, this does deter things, but this doesn't end things. You know what I mean? So I think it was a very smart move because it did get her the results that she wanted. So now you have an audience. You got that audience. Now you can do whatever you want. You can kill them off. You can just lay them off. Whatever you want to do. And then just focus on what you want to actually portray to the media in the get-go.
Aside from Tyler Perry, what are all black?
Kenya Barris has did it.
A lot of black shows got that one white best friend, though.
I think a lot of, like, even on this new Wonder Years, yeah, I see what you're saying, because, like, it's about a black family. You got that one white best friend. So I you see it happening all the time. I can't recall who, but someone had to get recast and was like, hey, no, you need to put a white person. Like, you need to cast a white person. So, like, me personally, I've never casted a white person. I've never even looked at a white person for anything. I got a new podcast that's coming out. Not me personally, but some people who I'm working with. And I remember a time someone asked me, like, hey, can I bring this white person on? And I was like, absolutely not.
That sounds like a policy under your production company?
It's not necessarily a policy. It's just that, you know, white people have a whole bunch of opportunities. They don't need one from me. You know, I'd rather get the opportunity to somebody else who looks like me. Mm-hmm. At this level I'm at now. Now, I'm not saying that I would never, ever work with someone who doesn't look like me, but I'm like, they don't need...
As of right now, you support me. Your community. Yeah,
absolutely. So when I write anything, when I cast anything, but maybe, I might be like, hey, this shit work for Issa.
If they hit you in the comments, you put a white person in there.
How much you paying me?
Doodoo.
You son Gasol. Got a Cash App.
So, I got Venmo.
But I guess it's about standing on your truth, because like Kyrie Irving right now is not playing basketball. He gonna miss the whole season because he refuses to get the COVID-19 vaccination. So he's missing out on his check. He said he's not retiring. He said he's just not gonna play basketball. I know you probably got some strong feelings about that.
I ain't got no strong feelings about that at all. I'm in agreement with you, bro. Stand your ground. If you don't want to get some shit, they trying to force you to get some shit, don't get it. Like, everybody has their own circumstances. You might be in a position where you have to, even though you don't want to, and that's understandable. You got to do what you got to do. However, in this specific instance for Kyrie, he does have the option.
He don't got to do.
So if I was in the same position, like not in this boat, but in this boat where I had the option of either you take this and you don't get paid, or you know, you take this and you get paid, or you don't take this and you don't get paid. If I got the money to already be sustaining on myself, fuck you. I ain't gotta do that. I'm gonna be straight regardless. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I get that point too. But then for also from a teammate point, like, I know, like, I don't want you to compromise yourself and your morals and your beliefs, but also there's no I in team, right?
Correct.
And all these people who's like, the research and now, over 600,000 people got the vaccine and none of them died from the vaccine. So it was like, what? It kills me when people are like, I'm doing my own research. Like, motherfucker, you used to stutter on a PowerPoint. Enough. Like, what kind of research your ass finna do?
Finna go on TikTok, look experience right. theories.
So that's my only thing where it's like, I don't mind you saying, like, you know, no, not for me. Especially people who are like holistic and like, I don't put nothing in my body. I get that. But it's like, what the fuck are you talking about? You know what I mean? Like,
I get you. It's a side to every story, for sure. But like you said, well, like I said.
Somebody said it.
One of us said it. You got to do what you got to do.
Yeah.
You have to get the vaccine to continue to be able to sustain your life. Let's not be naive.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I know people close to me who have had to go get the vaccine or else they would lose their jobs and not be able to take care of themselves and their family. And then I know people that don't do shit and it's like, I don't have to. And that, either way it goes, it's your decision. Don't feel like you got to be pressured into it by nobody, by the media, by other celebrities, what they got going on. Just focus on you. Do you want the vaccine? Yeah, nay.
But is there a question also of putting other people at risk too by you not getting it?
There is, like, but that's where we all have to practice our own safety.
Mm-hmm.
So like, if you vaccinated, all right. If you worried about other people not being vaccinated, better wear that motherfucking mask when you go to Walmart. Mm-hmm. Better continue to wash your hands. Mm-hmm. Just because you vaccinated don't mean that. System. Right. Just because you vaccinated don't mean you immune. Like, you can't get this shit again. You can. So it's literally all about taking care of yourself. Like, people can keep trying to push this agenda on we as a people got to do this. Man, we ain't been doing shit as a people for a long time. Don't try to switch up the narrative now.
Nah, they been arresting niggas and killing them for
just kidding.
Them people been doing that. But no, I get what you're saying.
The one that don't get casted. Right. No names.
What else? You said you had something to tag onto that?
I'm just spilling shit all over
there. I know. You off. and you grab my pillow, Vasco pillow,
this is a nice your pillow. But no, I'm with Vasco. I feel like, and I agree that there is no iron team, but at the end of the day, the individual has to take care of themselves. And I also think, and I'm vaccinated, but it's not my job to make sure that you don't get COVID. It's your job to make sure you're taking precautions and that you're building up your immune system and things like that, so that hopefully that you don't get it. And if you do get it, it's not that severe. My boyfriend doesn't have the vaccine still. And we live together. I, knock on wood, haven't had COVID. And if I have had it, haven't known about it. Yeah. So I think it's because both of us are, you know, generally pretty healthy and, you know, take the precautions and stuff. So,
yeah.
Hey, I didn't mean to interrupt. I know this isn't on the paper, but I finally finished Dave Chappelle.
Oh, okay. What'd you think?
I'm going to go ahead and let y'all know like this, bro. You not canceling Dave Chappelle. You not. This man, first of all, is solidified as a comedian. He's been talking his shit and talking his truth for the last how many years? Don't fact check me on it.
10, 15.
Whatever it may be. I just know it's been for a long time. And now, because everything is shifting, our society is trying to take former beliefs and say, F this. This is what we stand for now as a society.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't mean just because we agree or are supposed to agree, other people will agree. And Dave Chappelle is one of those outliers where he just feels as though, bro, I'm going to talk. Y'all not finna censor me. I.e., I don't want to conjure their anger with the alphabet community.
They call them what they are. LGBTQ+ community.
So I understand what he said in the special was actually very fucked up in some of, but at the same time, me being a fan, I don't know if this is being biased. Like, I understood that it was a joke. I understood it was seriousness in it, but I also understood the bigger like picture that he was trying to paint. You know what I mean? He's not coming for nobody, for real. He just telling these jokes. As he's telling these jokes, he's speaking about his experiences. And in telling about his experiences, he's telling like his truth. What he has experienced and what he know.
And he's telling people to stop being so damn sensitive.
That's all it is, bro.
You know, the irony to all of that was that a writer on Dear White People, I think, quit. But the writer on Dear White People was a white lady.
She's show runner or something like that.
I don't know if she was a showrunner for one season, but then I think she was a writer still on the show. Or maybe a producer. She quit Dear White People because of what Dave Chappelle said. And it's like, motherfucker, why are you writing a show called Dear White People for the voices of black people? And then next week, Netflix, the transgender employees at Netflix are supposed to be boycotting and walking out of Netflix.
On the 20th.
On the 20th. So it's like, motherfucker.
Okay.
All right.
You know how many people want to work for Netflix?
You definitely not going to stop Netflix.
That's what the co-CEO said. Like, all right. Because they was trying to pressure him to cancel, like, to pull it down. Oh. And he was like, no. He's like, I'm going to double down on it. No.
Bullshit on Netflix.
Netflix, right.
Like, it's cartoon. The anime shit.
Man, what?
It's wild stuff on there.
Who you telling?
And who's it targeted to? The kids. Yeah. So it's like, if people can pick and choose, you know what I'm saying, what to watch in that regard, you pick and choose what you want to watch. And if you don't like the shit, don't watch it.
And that's what he was saying. He basically said Netflix has a library of some of everything on it. He said from guns to guts to glory. He said, so if this is what's making you upset, watch something else.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Watch something else. Turn your channel.
You know what? I seen the announcement of Superman's son. I don't know if y'all seen that.
Coming out as bisexual?
Mm-hmm. If you don't want to watch it, don't watch it, correct? That's what you said?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To y'all who, and I'm not saying I'm against this whole Superman's son coming out as bisexual, but I'm trying to ask a question. To those who think that this is cool, this is all right, not saying it's not, but think that it is cool, think it's all right, how do you think a kid reading the comic book, seeing that, will feel?
They already think it's cool and all right.
Cool.
So my biggest thing, exactly. whenever someone says that, like, because I think I said it on the show before, whenever someone said they forcing this on you, because you said it a lot, they forcing this gay shit
on
you.
Yeah, I heard
they
this.
Forcing the LGBTQ, like, damn, they put it in the TVs, they put it on the news. Why Disney got two gay parents? Like, motherfucker, you know, at a point in time, about 60 years ago,
I knew
were saying the same shit about black people.
Yes, sir.
Why they forcing it? White people were saying the same shit about
y'all. I don't want to see that shit.
So
interracial couple.
So I'm not saying, like, I don't care either way.
Right.
You know what I mean? I don't give a damn either way. I'm not a Superman fan, so I'm not gonna watch it. But I'm not gonna not watch Dear White People because it's a gay black couple on there. Like, I don't. Black people always like, they're putting gay people. They trying to make every black man gay. Like no.
Ooh,
it's
black, especially black men love to.
I'm like, no. You got to realize, like, 60 something years ago,
yeah,
they were saying this about your daddy and your granddaddy and your grandma and your grandma. Why they trying to push these people on everybody? So my whole thing is, motherfucker, if you ain't fucking with me and my money and my life and how I'm living, do what the fuck you want to do and be happy.
Mm-hmm. Facts. 100%. 100%. And I wasn't asking that question to talk down anybody.
No,
I gotta clarify. Yeah. I love to clarify. Or to make anybody feel as though they're beneath, because everybody's equal, including LGBTQ community. Throwing it out there.
Just in case, driving the point home.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because some people love
hashtag,
to say
finish with scope.
Look,
he's trending next week. head honcho hype cancel.
They gonna fucking cut my ass.
Somebody said you the favorite. In the YouTube comments.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Mainly because you're from Georgia, is what
she
said.
Yeah, that is what she said. But I was gonna let you get your.
Somebody else said that you their spirit animal though.
Bro, hold on. Shout out to dude, because I definitely seen that comment on Instagram. I definitely replied very late because it was up under the stuff.
Because his name is Vasco, that's why he replied very late.
Anyways,
like, that's new. I replied very late. Nobody is surprised.
Hey, hold on. Hey, Veronica, did you laugh too? I thought I seen that.
Okay, all right.
Like, nobody here shocked.
I guess I'm the only one. All right.
Oh, really? Really? That's what happens.
To do, I appreciate that though, man. Yeah. to let me know that I'm your spirit animal, but that means you, sir.
You a wild boy. Hey. You a wild boy.
You fucking lit, son. Not son. Pops. OG.
Sir.
OG.
Mister. My guy.
Mister.
Right here.
Dude. Oh, I appreciate the love, though, for real, man. Mm-hmm. Hey, I can't. If I do get voted the favorite.
Are we taking votes on? I don't think that we're taking votes on who the favorite.
They volunteered that information.
I'm just playing.
Yeah. Come on, I'm always with it. But
There you go.
They just said
we're not
that.
In competition.
And I was just sharing with you.
So both of me.
Okay. Yeah. So speaking of everybody's favorite, R. Kelly. Why you taking your headphones off?
I'm going home.
Right.
So
I'm going home.
So y'all know YouTube pulled his official channels off of the YouTube site, like his music channels.
Mm-hmm.
But somehow his music has soared on the charts. Like he's up like 500% like with streams, which is crazy, huh?
So the R. Kelly club of like 40 to 60 year old women who
they
don't
say, y'all
believe
ain't
that he
them.
Right.
Y'all ain't canceling him.
No, he ain't do it. He wouldn't
he
do nothing like that.
Outside the courthouse like a damn fool.
They still on that. Yeah,
if you know somebody that was at that shit, let me know. I'm curious.
I think I said like I have like two R. Kelly songs that I will listen to.
Mm-hmm.
But I changed my mind.
Uh-oh.
I changed my mind. Okay. I would still listen to R. Kelly.
Mm.
As long as America was still saying the Star Spangled Banner, I still listen to R. Kelly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you sing the Star Spangled Banner?
I hum it sometimes. Just because I want to show up my soul that I know the
you
words.
You put your hand over your heart for the pledge?
Uh-uh.
Nah.
Oh, okay.
But I do stand up, stand erect. Do you stand up or put your hand over your heart for the pledge?
Man, I keep doing whatever I'm doing.
And
times have changed a lot.
So the reason, like I get what you're saying too, right? And I support what you're saying, but I did my because people be like, I don't know if you see a lot. Don't celebrate the 4th of July. Celebrate Juneteenth. Black people say that, but I'm like, you do realize if there wasn't no 4th of July, we'll be calling the British daddy still. So although
there would just be another Independence Day, like. All of Africa is not under British rule anymore.
No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about her here as an African American in America. Like you celebrate 4th of July for your that part of your heritage that says American. So you African American. So I like all the shit like that's fucked up about it. You got to also remember hundreds of slaves fought and died in a lot of those wars for Americans to be free. They don't like to acknowledge it, but for me, I stand up for those for my ancestors that fought and died in these American revolutions. So for me, that's that piece that I'll stand up to it. Now go look at the second stanza of the Star Spangled Banner, and then you'll be like, okay, y'all might want to remix this motherfucker.
Hold on.
I see what you're saying. Yes, all of that is true. But if the British were still in power, then it would, instead of it being one type of white people, it would be another type of white people.
Shit, your ass might still be a slave. Your ass might not be here.
Well, no, because there's not slavery in Britain. So,
yeah, man.
And in which country was it abolished first? I'm not sure.
I'm thinking it was America. I'm pretty sure some other smaller countries probably got rid of it first. They probably got overthrown. But I get your point, but what I'm saying is if you're going to be, well, this shit, just say you're black. Don't say you're African American.
That's what I'm
saying. Because your ass, I can tell you this, your ass don't want to go to Africa.
Man, right. I done heard this so many times.
Your ass ain't trying to go over there.
They don't fuck with us.
They don't.
No.
They going to look at your ass like you stink. Get the fuck out of here.
Bro, like, people
call yourself African American to an African. Watch how they tell you. You are American. You are not African.
No. You're not one of us.
No, I'm African American. No.
No.
Do you tell people, is that what you call yourself?
For African American?
Because I always just say I'm mixed.
Yeah, so, I'm
so
definitely
African American. So when you tell people, oh, Jared, what are, you know?
Black African American.
Which is first? I'm curious.
It's shit, curious. Tomato, tomato, shit.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I hit a black. Either I like, I
you
say.
You just say black?
I say, yeah, I'm black. Like, I ain't got nothing missing me, I'm black. And then I hit, if I'm talking like my friends or somebody I can be a little bit more casual with.
I'm a thoroughbred nigga.
I'm a nook.
But when I gotta fill that paper out, that census form is gonna say black / African American.
Yeah.
No, I was just curious what you say in conversation.
Not Latino. Or Hispanic.
Not Hispanic.
Mm-hmm.
Do y'all have a section where you can say mixed? Or do you circle black?
I if it's just one race that I can choose, I choose black. If I could choose more than one, then I choose black, white, and Native American.
You Native American too?
Mm-hmm. You got okay. Cherokee blood.
Yeah. That's what everybody know. Say. Boy. You know, I got Indian in my family. What kind
real
of Cherokee?
Real recognized, real
recognized.
Real recognized.
Nobody worried about him.
Also circle shit.
Yeah. Cherokee in me.
You know. My grandma told me that. You got Indian blood running through you. Ooh! Big way!
My grandma and them got the papers.
I'm
not here
like Pocahontas, huh?
I said they got the papers and stuff.
Indians own slaves.
Just around the river, man!
What'd you say?
That's culture appropriate. You ain't supposed to be doing that no more.
Yeah, I can't say that.
You can't say just around the river bend no more.
That's a great song.
Pocahontas was fucking that white man. They was mad at her. Then they canceled on Pocahontas.
Yeah.
For fucking John Smith.
Man, it was. And Mulan.
What Mulan did? Why does
it
matter?
Because it was. It's like she sexist.
She broke the
you know,
heritage.
The beginning of it and the songs. And a lot of the songs are sexist. Whenever they're marching and they're talking about what a good.
Hey, man.
What do we want? One more fighting for? I want a girl that cooks
girl
my food.
A girl worth fighting for.
I want a girl that looks beautiful. Like, they
wish
don't.
That I had a girl worth fighting. We ain't finna
she's
disrespect.
She's not supposed to go to
Mulan
war
because
she's a woman.
Trick.
No, I love Mulan. I'm just saying what
I'll make
saying.
A man out of you is number one on my damn Disney soundtrack.
How'd that go? I'll make a man out of you?
Somehow I'll make a man.
And she put the thing around that tree.
Don't sign over Mulan is.
Eyes of forest. Oh my God.
Is that girl I see staring straight back at me? When will my reflection show who I am inside? You know. That's when Casey and Jettle took over.
That's what I wanted to ask you. You hear R. Kelly, what's the first song to come to your head?
R. Kelly?
Yeah. Go.
Damn it. First one to come to my head, I gotta sing it.
Oh.
Don't front, you know, about the rodeo show. So shorty, it's on my D-E, for I get knee deep into you. I don't see nothing wrong.
Okay.
First one coming to your head with R. Kelly. Not that we promote R. Kelly.
I'm forever indebted.
When a woman loves. So how you gonna not listen to him? Like, it's fucked up.
If it come on, I listen.
Okay.
But I ain't searching.
Damn, bro.
It doesn't come on often.
I used to listen to R. Kelly like before, like when I was playing, what's it called? The little football league around here.
Pop Warner.
That's what they called it. Uh-huh. I was doing that back home, and we used to, my dad would play like some of the songs, but only the lit ones.
Yeah.
And I used to listen to, I'm a rock star, baby.
Oh, that was
yeah. But that's what I used to listen to. Like, couple, you ain't like that?
That was a good song.
I'm like 7-8 in the
That's not the first one people go to when they think of R. Kelly.
Rockstar, let me
What you about
eight years old?
See you. Then R. Kelly also had rolling through the hood, just stop by to say what's up. Let you know your baby boy ain't doing so tough. Even though your past gone on four long years, still waking up late at night crying tears. Just thinking about the ways you used to talk to me, smiling while I'm sipping on this Hennessy. Remember we bragged about how rich we would be, and thinking about this hood was like a fantasy.
They can get rid of R. Kelly.
The radio was playing. Oh, I can't believe my ears and what everybody's saying.
Wouldn't hear any more R. Kelly.
And boy, I tell you, folks don't know the half.
Just keep listening to
I give it all up just to take one ride with you.
How I used to.
Anything you want to hear.
Then with you.
We have
how
that
we
and more.
Go down church on Easter Sunday.
With you. My condolences. Nigga, that one. I promise this is the last one.
Oh, I love that one.
I am a mountain.
Oh, okay.
I am a Leo. Oh, I am a lion. Down in the jungle.
He had some bangers.
He had some hits.
And it's unfortunate.
Don't free his ass. I ain't going to say free Kells, but.
We're anti-Kells. Well, I'm anti-Kells, but those songs hit.
Those songs are definitely
those songs slap.
Slap.
So, my wife told y'all we want to go see Hamilton last night.
Alexander Hamilton.
Why you said it like that? Yeah.
My name is Alexander.
I'm the only one that don't know, so I'm gonna let y'all.
You have to watch it on Disney Plus. That's one thing.
Yeah, I started it.
Did you really?
Yeah, I got like 16 minutes.
You didn't like it?
No.
Okay. Well, maybe it's not for you.
Do they have a motion picture one? I know that they're recording people on stage, but if I could see the actual movie of it, then maybe I could.
I think eventually they're probably gonna make a motion picture one, but right now, no, that's not a.
Because I don't mind a singing movie. But anyways, back to it. Okay, so how was it?
It was great. I don't know why you don't like it. Why you did? Everybody who I put onto it, like at first they was like, you like, I ain't fuck with that shit. Hell no. Mm-hmm. But now they're like, my name is Alexander Hamilton. And there's a million things I haven't done. But just you wait.
Don't fucking play with no Alexander Hamilton.
You gotta go see it, Basco. I think next week, last week.
I was at work yesterday. Customer come up to me, had the Alexander Hamilton. I want to be in the room where it happens.
They go crazy. They turn to freaks by Hamilton.
Have you seen it?
I was like, I ain't probably gonna be able to make it this time, man. I know the tickets was already up there. Now they gonna be even more up there.
Now you gonna be already up there.
She told me, she was like, you'll still be able to see everything though. It's still a great view.
Bring your glasses. Cause we had pretty decent seats. I was like, is that Aaron Burr, sir? The fuck going on?
Excuse me.
Is that Aaron Burr, sir? I couldn't see shit from where I was. And I had my glasses on. But no, it was, I think the only curve is that, so everybody in the play, and we had the little booklet. They're like actors and Broadway people. Like some of them are in movies and,
The marquee.
Yeah, the marquee. Yeah, so I couldn't. You don't know who they are because they're in character. But like one of the guys is from the show Grown-ish. One of the ladies is from like This Is Us. Like different kind of movies and shows. I was like, oh, that's cool that they're here.
Right.
But the only thing is like, I've been singing Hamilton on Disney Plus for a year, so getting over that curve of like, okay, y'all doing it different.
I hate that.
Y'all taking y'all own.
Spin to it.
Not like word for word, still the same words, but like they making their own creative choices.
Different inflections at different parts.
Different inflections. The king didn't have a deep voice. His voice was a little raspy.
Was he still funny?
It was nasally.
He was funny. Somebody, I think that might be Vasco Cord. He was still funny a little bit. But it was a little different. So that was the only learning curve. But I would say if you're in here and you're able to see it in Jacksonville, or if it comes to you, I think it's going to New York next. So if it's coming to you, go watch
it out.
Don't be a hater like Vanessa. If Vanessa would just watch it,
I'll try it one more time.
You gonna try it one more time?
One more time, because I do like Downton Abbey.
I don't know what that is.
You know what Downton Abbey is?
Mm-mm. It's on Disney?
No, it ain't on Disney.
What is it?
I thought it was down. I thought you were saying Downtown.
It's the show, and it came out with a movie. It used to be a series on PBS, and it's about the rich family that lives in
a
mansion.
Oh my god!
If you seen Down,
do they sing on it?
They wear the wig.
No, they don't sing on it. It's like historical fiction.
They wear the wigs.
Yeah, they wear.
They
dress up for dinner.
Yeah.
But it shows like the difference of like how they change like over the course of like 30 years. So at the beginning they like reel into that Victorian style.
It's like The Crown.
Oh.
Kind of, sort of. And then eventually like a black character gets introduced, and they show like how they would have dealt with a black character, and then the telephone gets introduced.
I might watch it just for the progression.
It's interesting if you like history.
I had a question. This is changing gears from where y'all was at. But I went to the Jaguars game last week too. They had a big ass on their big ass jumbotron. Whenever they get a first down, make that sound again. Move them chains.
Yeah,
hey.
Move them chains. That's all you.
I was like, hey, we heard that sound about two times. And then one of them, they brought it back. Move them chains. Flag. Oh fuck. Well, but no. So this weekend coming up. Well, this weekend that we're in now, if you're watching the show, it's my first weekend off, I think. And I ain't really off because shit, we got stuff to do for the live show. But it's my first weekend not having to work in a while. Like probably since June.
Was that just nice? Was it nice?
Hmm?
Was it nice?
Well, no. I'm gonna let you know when I get there.
For sure.
Yeah, I'm gonna let you know. But I was curious. Vanessa, I think this question is for the ladies, right? I was driving in my car to work for the ladies.
Driving in your car to work.
Everybody who know him.
Let me get in picture.
Well, that's a question for the ladies. So would you want a man who worked and could only spend, say, 8 hours out of a month with you? Or would you want a man who worked part-time at McDonald's but could spend all the time that you want? And just to put it into context, there's about 730 hours in a month, but he can only spend 8 with you. Would you want a man who worked can only spend 8 hours out of 730 with you, or a man who worked part time, not even at McDonald's, say at Walmart, work part time, but had all the time to spend with you, what would you prefer?
Go to work.
And you gonna only stay for 8 hours.
We're gonna make the best out of those 8 hours.
Ooh.
Yes. No. I need you to go on to work.
Okay.
Because even when we hanging out, I don't be doing shit, and I don't like too much talking when I get home, anyways. So yeah.
Okay. Take your ass to work.
No, we almost got into it last night.
No.
Cause I'll be watching something, and then in the middle, especially if it's something that he don't want to watch, he'll like ask a whole bunch of questions and make a whole bunch of jokes in the middle of it. And it's like, damn, I don't do this whenever you watch or something you want to watch.
Yeah.
Just shush.
I don't do this when Naruto.
I didn't say that, but I was just like,
your face said it.
I said, baby, why are you doing that? I don't do that to you. And then I put my earpods in and watched it on my phone.
Oh.
For the next 3 episodes.
And you just compromised.
And then afterwards, I felt like that was a compromise. Yeah. But he was like, damn, am I getting on your nerves? And did I do something? And I was like, no, baby, you're not on my nerves. This helps you not be on my nerves, right?
Without these, you might be.
So, yeah, no, go to work.
That's good. What you say? So if your girl worked only could see you 8 hours out the month and it's 730, and not like 1 8 hours in a day, like 1 8 hour day, like this, whenever we can get it in, we can get it in.
Mm-hmm. Hey, man, I gotta get that bread. I got to.
Mm-hmm.
I love my lady. My lady loved me. However, you know that song. Anyway,
is that Busta Rhymes? By Plies.
I was thinking about shit. Ray Charles. Well, Mr. Charles, I love the Lord. The Lord loves me, but I ain't no hypocrite.
No, bro, I gotta get that money though. Eight
hours out of 730. Part time at Walmart, making $15 an hour. She makes decent money.
You don't want up in Walmart.
No. Like, I wouldn't be happy about the situation. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I'd rather be able to see you a little bit more often, but still be able to be steady. And Walmart making 15, 16
Walmart,
starting
Walmart
out.
Is straight money.
Yeah, so, I mean, if it's Wally World.
Definitely cheating.
Yeah. Huh?
Definitely cheating.
Yeah. 15,
I mean, people can cheat anywhere. Walmart. But Walmart, you see everybody. All the time, nonstop.
And you gone for 722 hours? I wouldn't trust her.
Mm-mm. And working at Wally World? You wouldn't trust me working at Wally World?
There's a couple places.
Walmart, Metro, PCS, any
call
phone company.
Center,
Family Dollar.
Dollar Tree.
The gym.
The gym, I don't
know about that.
Hey, concierge at a hotel.
Oh, yeah. That's
yeah, concierge at a hotel. Hold on, Vasco, because so it's a couple places.
Put that down for top five.
What?
Top five places cheaters work.
Yeah, that's a good. police station, police officers, hospitals. I watch Grey's Anatomy.
Any type of secretary.
Traveling nurse,
but yeah.
But for that
flight attendant,
type of money,
you don't just
deal with it.
Physical therapist.
Physical therapist. Yeah, I see these new dudes giving these sensual massages.
I have.
Are you signing up for one?
It looks interesting.
Yo, boy.
I thought about it.
I don't want to speak for yo. I'll knock your head smooth the fuck off. And I'm saying it on this podcast.
Why?
I'll bring it from here. I'll bring it from the hill. And smooth the...
Okay, blink twice, though, if it looks enjoyable.
I'll knock your head back. You know what I'm talking about?
I thought about that. I
can imagine it though.
It's a lot. They give them like basically fucking, no. But it's a massage. They fucking
hand fucking.
Yeah, all on your booty. There ain't no muscle in there. What you rubbing?
Everybody likes their butt rubbed.
Man,
not by no damn masseuse.
I don't like my booty rubbed.
One of the girls sitting on him like.
Yeah, the girls straddling them.
That's a lot, but still, it looks very soothing.
What the hell is soothing about that? I'll knock your head clean from here to orange.
Soothing?
Part.
Ladies, let me know. Would you get one of those sensual massages?
I'll knock your head from here to orange.
We can go as a couple.
You go get him here.
I want shorty. Bring that ass in.
You gonna sit on you?
Mm-mm. You gotta turn around. Back only.
Hey, you just said shorty.
No, Jill's in the front.
No,
yeah.
Okay. So, but if we both laying down,
all right.
Yeah,
look, nigga,
we got oil in here. That's what you want.
I got hands.
Nigga, I'll be apple all in your
and
ass.
They certified. What's wrong with you? Yeah. Mm-mm. Both ways.
Shit.
Yeah, man, we got a massage table at the house.
Y'all do? Mm-hmm. Who was in massage therapy school?
He bought that. Oh, he bought it. He's giving me massages before. Sometimes I like come home. It's been a while, but yeah, every once in a while, yeah, I come
he
home.
He bought it when y'all were together, or he had it when y'all.
Oh no, he bought it since we got together.
Okay, I was gonna say that's a nice little ploy to get a. No. Hey, yeah, man, I do massages.
Right as soon as you open the door.
RIP my Uncle Allen, when he got out of jail, he went to massage therapy school. We always look like, you nasty nigga. We know what the fuck.
We know what's up.
Yeah, I do massages, baby. I do massages.
How long you been doing? Probably a good way to get ladies.
Yeah,
if you do massages.
learning them little pressure points, learning what to hit them at, learning what to say when you're in it, and what to do when you're doing it.
You find out all the spots where you even get in there.
You think so?
Yeah. Rubber the probably on the fucking ears, the back of the neck. Ooh.
That's what they said again? Ooh. That's what they say?
Don't do that. I like it. Oh, do you know?
When you look at, that's where you was going with it. I know. The Millennial Tour is coming up. Hey, we got a live show coming up too. Speaking about stuff coming up, y'all ready?
Yeah. Yo.
Coming.
Should it be a movie?
I think tickets are sold out, so I don't know if we can promote it, but yeah, you ain't got your ticket by the time you hear this.
I guess you can like watch the reruns on Instagram or something.
So, I guess it's an off-air question. Never mind.
Okay. Yeah. So you ain't got your ticket now. You just ain't gonna get it.
That's so well.
That's awesome. So proud of us.
Yeah.
Hey. Drop a bomb for us for having a sold out event. Can we call this our first one?
Yeah. Right.
What?
It really is our first event.
I wanted to sell more tickets to where we was running into an issue with capacity and COVID and all that good stuff. So I was like, damn.
Y'all heard that?
Damn, Gina. Damn, Daniel. Back in the game.
We got almost a month to sell if we could.
You said it again?
I said we got almost a month.
To sell more,
to
yeah.
To keep selling, but. No, I'm excited.
Yeah,
I don't know what I'm going to wear. I mean, I have an idea, but I'm not sure.
I ain't got no fucking clue.
So are we going to match? I know.
Color scheme for sure, I think.
Like fall colors.
I've been told no patterns.
Who told you that?
Our
producer.
Our producer. Okay. We're going colors.
Solid colors. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
I'm going to get a little more jazzy than normal.
Okay. What's jazzy?
Just a touch more jazzy.
The fuck is a touch of jazzy?
Just a splash. Just a splash of hazelnut, okay? So, I'm excited.
I'm excited.
Man. I'm ready.
Let's go. I told you, bro. It's finna be a movie. We finna be lit. Y'all heard what the man said.
Go ahead, Vasco.
We had capacity problems, bro. We was running into capacity problems, bro.
Oh, can we do a shout-out? Shout-out to DJ B-Tune, who is the official DJ. And then shout out to comedian Bobby Brown Jr., who is the opening comedian. So,
yes, sir.
We got some people coming in.
Oh, yeah.
Bobby Brown Jr. No, not that Bobby.
Oh, okay.
That Bobby Brown Jr. actually passed away, but this Bobby Brown Jr.
Sorry.
it's okay. I mean, you ain't know him personally.
That's a good conversation starting name.
Bobby Brown Jr.? Yeah, it is. Right, hey, what's your name? Bobby Brown Jr. Are you related to?
Well, actually.
Nah.
I was going to give you $50,000 if you were.
I start hitting that shit too. And you know y'all getting bored dealing with him. I know you miss my loving, my thug and thug loving. And I know y'all getting bored, baby.
I'm glad y'all enjoy our singing.
I do too. Yo, listen, it's your boy Jay the Great, and we're going right straight from social media. So y'all been seeing us on social media about the red flags.
Oh my God. I'm tired of seeing
it. It's all up and down the line.
So I'm tired of seeing the red flags now, but I'm a little, you know, I'm like, okay, all right.
They're funny, some of them.
So a lot of them are funny, especially when I posted today about if they interview you and hire you on the same day.
You put that? Flag.
No, I shared it.
Oh,
I
was going to say, damn, I see somebody else in there.
No, I shared it. I shared it. Again, right?
Again.
No, I shared that one. So we talked to some of the listeners, right? Mm-hmm. And they were talking about some of their relationship red flags. So I'm just going to bring them on here and just hear what they say. Then we can chime in or not.
Okay.
Then we're going to see what you want to say. What are some of your relationship red flags? What you
it's
got?
A red flag if she's not cool like with her parents.
If she's not cool with her parents, that's a red flag. Mm. That's a red flag for y'all?
Yeah.
Kinda.
For me, yeah.
Cause y'all.
I'm big
I'm
on
only
family.
A family. Yeah,
yeah. I'm big on
that's
family.
That's the only reason.
So yeah, if she's not cool with her parents, that's a red flag for me too. Mm. What you got? What's a red flag?
I would say mine would have to be if a guy doesn't have nothing going for himself,
nothing going for himself. That's a red flag.
That's a huge. That's the biggest red flag.
If you ain't doing nothing,
how you gonna provide for me? You ain't providing for yourself.
That's a good question.
Make it make sense.
What's your red flag?
Whenever they degrade or tell you whatever you like is stupid or dumb or uninteresting, something like that.
Hey man,
you that's
ain't
a
finna,
good one.
You ain't finna sit here and tell me you don't like anime.
That's stupid. Oh, is it?
Is it?
Watch this. What's your red flag?
Bruh, it's when she don't have no savings account. No financial history, no good credit, all of that. You know, no romance without finance.
No romance without finance.
If you was broke,
how soon should you ask somebody about their credit score?
This is y'all question.
No, nigga, you got a credit score.
It's coming on.
I don't know. Me, as soon as, like, first date, I'm throwing darts. Like, I'm asking a whole bunch of questions. So I don't see that being abnormal for me to ask on the first date.
Hey, what's your credit score? That's a little personal, ain't it, Vanessa?
Yeah, it is. You don't want to answer it? Okay, no problem. So what you eating? Like, I don't care. But
just breeze through it. Bring it back up 3 hours later.
Yeah.
So remember that question you didn't want to ask earlier? Let's delve back into that.
So you
why you don't want to talk about that?
Me and my wife, I don't think I found out what her credit score was until we was getting ready to move in together. And she looked at me like, you going to make it? You going to get approved? I'm going to get approved? Because shit, we going to see.
You look. Let's say at least a year and 2 years before you. If you starting to think, damn, we could live together for real, for real. Like an apartment is not in my mind, for real, for real.
Right.
Stepping stone. Yeah. So I can see us living together for real. Okay, now I ask.
Okay. Yeah.
Apartment is for real, for real. That's a lease. What's your red flag?
Yes, the red flag is that trust. It's a difference between checking in versus someone that's always calling you 1,000 times saying, hey, where are you? How is work? What's going on? What time are you coming back? And he's got the same schedule.
That's not somebody don't sound you got caught cheating.
That's a red flag. No, they ain't got nothing to do. They bored.
Checking in.
Are they cheating? They don't want to run into you while they out there doing what they doing. Where you gonna be? Where you gonna run to? What you gonna do?
I don't like when he asks me, well, what are you doing and when time will you be back? Don't worry about it. I'll be the one to get done.
That's what you said?
Sometimes.
Jeez, Vanessa. What's your red flag?
Basically, inconsistency. For real, that's like one of the main ones. Like, you kind of like keep stuff going, interested in them again, and next thing you know, you started falling. I'm like, nah, we good. Just shut that down.
Shut that down, sis.
Inconsistency is a red flag, Vanessa.
That means he don't really like you like that. Or she don't really like you like that. To me, that's how I interpret inconsistency.
No, that's big facts, bro. Yeah. I need to know a little something about you. And if you just continue to switch up every other day, who am I talking to? I don't know.
What's your red flag?
My number one red flag is if you're just surrounded by mess. Because I hate being involved in drama. Especially drama that just don't even need to be there from the beginning. That's like the main thing for me. And then the second thing was underneath that is if you don't have any type of intelligence at all.
Damn!
The mess one is big.
That makes me think of the first one.
What?
With not close to their family.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't like drama. Yeah. What's your red flag?
If the crib dirty, red flag.
Yes, sir.
If the car messy, red flag.
Yes, sir.
Because, like, let's keep it real. Any girl I'm rocking with, if her crib clean, her car clean, her life usually be clean. Like, it be a clean life. You get what I'm saying? She got her stuff together. You know what I mean?
A messy environment can cause a messy mindset.
I envy and wonder.
Vanessa car dirty as fuck.
It's not dirty, but there's a lot of different stuff in my car, like Expo markers, extra pair of shoes for a kid who might not have. Like, I got a lot of different things going on. So
you
it's a difference between like dirty and
living.
Just a lot of shit in there.
Yeah, it's okay to live out the car sometimes. Yeah. I got a lot of shit in the car, but it's still clean.
She born.
What's your red flag?
You're overreacting to something that's so tiny that has nothing major as the way you think it is. That's like a number one major red flag that I noticed. Also, not being validated. When you are sitting there speaking on your emotions on side, the number one thing is you get shut down. That's a huge red flag. And those two main things is the quickest way to figure out if you with a narcissist as well.
What the fuck are you dealing with at home?
Damn.
You came with that nigga.
What was the first one?
I forgot. She said a lot.
Ooh. All I know is
not being validated.
No, that was two. That second one. I agree with that. Like, if I'm spilling my whole heart out of you, just telling you about my day and I'm emotional about it, like, bro, just beat up. You know what I'm saying? Oh wow! Really?
I don't
need you to know the whole plot the way it ended, the way it started. You know what I'm saying?
And then you hear me say that's crazy. Wrap your story up.
Yeah,
wrap your story up.
Starting to lose.
What's your red flag?
I want to share two. One of the red flags would be when you first start dating someone or you get in a relationship with someone, and they talk badly about their ex. Oh, they was trash. Oh, they was this. Oh, they didn't do this right. Oh, they didn't do that right. That is a red flag. That is a red flag. And it's normally an indicator of that person trying to train that new person on what they want and what they expect in the relationship. The second one I would say is anybody who tries to, you date for a short period of time, and they bring up marriage really quickly. Like, all of a sudden, you guys been, probably dating maybe, a month, 2 months, 3 months. And it's like, oh, you my soulmate. Oh, we need to jump in, into I want to be committed to you. I want to, those are indicators of a red flag, because that person is trying to get committed to you quick so you won't see the true them.
Trap you 100%, man.
Let's go. What's some of your red flags?
Hey man, this goes out to the fellas, man, still trying to perfect y'all scrolls. If you ask her who meow this is, and all she do is moan,
you gonna steal that straight off of social media?
Hell yeah! I said, hey, look, I picked the best one.
That shit before.
Hey man, just go ahead and finish up what you got to do, and then get the fuck up out of there. Then it probably gonna happen again. That's one red flag. You got a red flag?
Oh, red flag for me is she still wear the sock bun, but she using a white sock and you can kind of still see the white sock. That's a red flag. If she's still wrapping her hair in a bun and with using a sock and you can just a white sock, that's a big ass red flag.
Nelson?
No job, no car.
No job, no car?
Either or a combination of the two. There.
Here go another red flag. If the inside of her jeans standing, that means she wore them jeans too much.
Oh,
it's her favorite pair.
Mm-mm, they thinner. You gotta get you another pair of them jeans.
We just all go got buy the same flag. One.
And you know what I'm saying? Why can't you?
You know how much
that?
A pair of good jeans is for real?
Yeah. Here go another one. If her bra strap's dirty, brown, you gonna take her white bra off, and then her strap's brown. Ugh.
If she FaceTime, if her friends FaceTime her, and then they say show is him, and she don't need the phone, but that's a red flag. She only panties to you. That's a red flag. Go ahead and go home.
If she can't cook nothing but Alfredo, it's a red flag.
His phone always face down.
Red flag.
That's definitely a red flag.
That was good. Oh, yeah.
If she talk about these friends all the time and you ain't never meet these friends, red flag.
He's just a brother.
Red flag. That's my cousin. Red flag. It don't count. Red flag.
Man.
Wait, those two don't count. Red flag.
Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here.
That's straight from social media, man. Y'all let us know in the comments, what are some of y'all red flags? And, I'm just curious. I'm curious, what do y'all see as being red flags? Let's go!
Yo. No? Okay.
You try to hit a note.
Hey, I wasn't even mad.
I want to point this out. I don't know if y'all remember this. About a year ago or so now, when me and you was here, we were comfortable. Vasco was pretty new. This nigga didn't want to sing at all. You remember that? This nigga was opposed to singing.
Hell yeah.
Not this nigga over here leading songs. Not this nigga got solo.
I found my voice. Thank you, identified delinquents.
I was thinking about that. I was like, damn, I said, I remember it was a point in time Vasco wouldn't sing Hamilton with me. Not this nigga over here, Aaron Burr, sir.
Bro, you know what? That's how you got me set up. Fucking Hamilton, that's what started it. Oh, he liked Hamilton.
I'm gonna
start playing this.
That
nigga playing Hamilton a week, every day for that week. And we wanna be in the room where it happens.
I was like, Vasco, go back and watch the episode from like a year, I was gonna say years ago. Man. From last year, Vasco hated singing. Look at them now.
Just watch that one episode and then come on back.
Yeah, come on back. Because some of y'all still, by the time y'all get to this episode and you made it to this point, we in 2025. See how we done grown?
Keep going.
Yeah, come on up.
I know you want to learn more about
it. I see people from TikTok, they be doing it all the time. Like, I'm here from TikTok, like, bitch, from Breeze and Bree. Like, come on, we done got better.
Yeah, just come on in.
They hit the change. Come on.
Go see the new shit. The latest video. Not the one that went crazy.
Yeah, come on up here. Let's go.
Yo.
Question of the day, bro.
Hey, man. Got a couple questions. Let me ask. Question of the day. Yo, what it is, what it do, man. It's your boy Sko. And question of the day for today. If you only had $100 to feed 50 people, what are you making? I ask in, what dish are you making?
That's easy.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Shut up.
I'm going with spaghetti and garlic bread.
Okay.
You can't miss. With some of the Texas frozen bread. Because yeah. How much that's is ground true. Beef? Ground beef ain't that expensive. Yeah, by $5 you get a pack. You know, Jesus fed 100 people with a loaf of bread and some fish. So I can feed you 50 with $100. Garlic bread, spaghetti.
50 people, though.
50 people, yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm not disagreeing with you.
And you can come back and get a little bit more. You might be able to take a plate home. As a matter of fact, I might have too much food. And as a matter of fact, I can get you some corn on the side. Damn. So you got some spaghetti, you got some corn.
You got a four corn meal right here.
And you got some garlic bread right
there. That's a good one. Yeah. That's a good one.
So the spaghetti, mm-hmm. I was going to say
but now what you can't do, if you're going to do spaghetti like that, what you can't do is not mix the sauce and the noodles. You got to mix it up.
Because
then niggas going to go crazy with the meat sauce. And they're going to have a little bit of noodles. One damn noodle. Big ass thing of meat sauce, so you gotta mix that up.
Can they get Parmesan cheese on the top?
They can get a little Parmesan, and as a matter of fact, I could put a little cheddar on it and put the thing back on top and let it melt. So then when you go to stir your cheese, stir it up, it's cheese all in there. Everybody cheesy for cheesy.
Oh, that makes me think.
I don't know if I want to make this difficult to myself.
Chili would also be a good one.
Okay.
Hot dogs,
cornbread,
and
with
chips.
Chili?
No cornbread.
No cornbread.
Do burgers.
Well, if we do the Jiffy.
Okay, yeah, that's one thing. Yeah,
that's
a little box.
Yeah.
About how many boxes of Jiffy?
You only need lots of boxes.
Okay.
But you can get two for a dollar.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. But, and okay, for okay. Whatchamacallit, all you need is the beans, the meat, and what else?
Shit, I don't know what.
Besides your seasonings.
Tomatoes.
Oh, yeah, right, tomato paste. But
some spices.
All of that is canned goods. So yeah. It's not much. Hot dogs and chips.
You feeding kids. You talking about grown ass people?
One type of chip.
Frito-Lay.
Doritos.
Okay.
Doritos. Cool Ranch.
That's all your money right there. Shit.
Yeah, exactly. I don't need nothing left over. Last thing, chicken and rice. And I say,
how much chicken?
You get the whole chicken.
A whole pack of chicken,
so maybe
is like 8-11.
You get three whole chickens.
Or nine. It could range from them.
Boil that thing up and put that junk in the. Yeah.
Oh, like Perlo rice.
Hmm?
Like Perlo rice.
Perlo rice.
Yeah.
What okay. You call it?
That's what I think that's what it's called.
Oh, I don't. I thought it was called chicken and rice.
That's like when you last week when you mix it together, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Perlo rice. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Learned something new today. Let's go.
You guys got me fucked up. You literally said what I was gonna say. Then you said what I was gonna say after what he said what I was gonna say. So at this point, y'all gonna eat, but y'all might not get fulfilled. So for $100, we're gonna go with a pack of chicken. That's like nine.
How many pieces? I'm like, what kind of like.
The breast, chicken breast.
Okay.
I like the, yeah, because I can slice them boys up into little things and then
okay.
Three,
say,
four.
He's going to
slice them with the tenders.
Right, you feel me? We're going to have some tenders,
mm-hmm.
Some beanie weenies, some hamburgers, some chips, the fun pack, spicy.
So everybody's going to get like half a hamburger.
And ramen noodles and
damn,
it's a
buffet, but it's a small buffet.
Y'all going to have the whatchamacallit, going to get the door fruit, the fruit can.
That's no, the little you can
one
juice.
Scoop, nigga. You get one scoop,
and you can drink that as juice. So they're gonna use
exactly.
Yeah.
Well, actually, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and make the best out of this. We're gonna open up a little bit and pour by half the juice in like each cup. And
yeah.
We're gonna ward it down,
stretch it
exactly, and then throw a spoonful of sugar. And then now you got
some Kool-Aid, dog Kool-Aid.
What?
Kool-Aid packs, 10 cents. Put a little bit of that in there.
And then, you know what I'm saying? We're going to throw in the motherfucker, the Reese's Cup, because they had the 28.
individual, this one cup.
Can you imagine walking into a room or a venue and Vasco's like, yeah, what's up, man? Welcome, everybody. And then he's like, this is what we got. So we got, you know, rum noodles.
You got the beanie weenies over here.
Half hamburgers here. Half no hamburgers. Cheese, no ketchup, no nothing. Just
no condiments.
You got condiments?
We got
condiments. Because condiments is about,
he got the free ones from Publix and the little thing.
Okay.
No, I'm going to look.
You buy the variety pack at $7. At Sam's.
No. We're going to have condiments, but it's going to be one bottle per each thing. And y'all fuck that up. You fuck it up. You have to ask somebody to scrape off
so
the plate.
So the 49th person.
You fucked.
Right. Okay.
Just like right. Squid Game.
You can do that. The kids will love that shit.
Exactly. And adults, if you hungry enough, you're going to love it too.
Let's go.
Y'all, hey, y'all make the ramen noodles with the shrimp and the sausage and all of that?
Yes.
I'd be wondering
if you just spent 60 more cent, you could go get a pack of noodles and just make a regular pasta.
True. No, you could, here's the thing. Sometimes you ain't got the pasta on you, but you be hungry in that moment. I got ramen, this one pack of ramen noodles on deck.
So bump the trip.
Let's get busy. Fuck the trip. I'm hungry now. Let's get busy. I just need some water, salt and pepper, maybe even some soy sauce if I'm feeling fancy. Yeah, I got ground beef and chicken, and we finna get busy.
You put the ground beef in it?
No.
In your noodles?
No. I might have like a little patty on the side, make like an actual meat patty. To some A1 sauce in that bitch. You got A1 sauce. You got some nice ass.
Talking about your noodle noodles, right?
No. I'm talking about the actual steak patty.
Talking about steak or
ground. So you take the ground beef,
right? And then
roll
you're
this bitch up,
it
make
into
it to a patty, and then cook that whole up like regular. So now you got a beef patty, and so you got your ramen noodles as well.
You got a hamburger,
no bread,
no bun,
no condiments, no
on
cheese
on the side of your ramen noodles
that you know cooked up all fancy.
Right, exactly.
Okay. Only thing go in my noodles, I leave a little bit of water in there.
It's
like,
the damn seasoning.
Yeah.
That's it.
I put the seasoning in there, and I do like a little bit of butter. Like literally just a little bit.
That's interesting.
I never did that.
Yeah, do like a little bit, but like leave like a little bit of water in there, and then put the seasoning, maybe a little pepper.
Yeah.
And then like
your own shit.
Like a little thing of butter, and just stir it up.
What's your go-to ramen?
Chicken.
Yeah, I like chicken too. Chicken, I do shrimp occasionally.
Or
the spicy chicken.
Spicy or chili.
I don't like the beef.
You don't like chili?
I don't like the creamy chicken.
I don't like the creamy chicken. I don't like the chili, no. I don't even fuck with the beef.
Really just the chicken, honestly.
Yeah, the chicken one is probably.
Chicken with, I always throw hot sauce and everything, so. A little two dabs.
I almost never eat hot sauce. That might be this side of me.
Yeah, I don't eat it either. I might have some of that in me too.
Okay.
Close your segment out, Skull, man.
Hey, man. Y'all heard it here first, bro. Question of the day. If you only had $100 to feed 50 people, 50, what dish would you make?
I say I got a couple questions.
Let me ask you.
Let me get back. Question of the day.
What's up, y'all? It's your boy Jerry the Gray,
your favorite cousin Vasco,
and your girl Nessa Ness.
If you're in Duval County or the surrounding areas, make sure you get your tickets to check us out live.
Did you say live?
In person.
It all goes down Wednesday, November 10th, right here in Jacksonville, Florida, at the Hookah Spot Lounge.
No kizzy, this is about to be lit, so make sure you get your tickets today.
Hey, I promise you don't want to miss this one. The Dignified Delinquents Live. Tickets are going fast, so get yours today. See y'all in November. Nessa!
Yes.
Well, before you go, I had a question.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw this on my Twitter feed, and it bothered me.
Okay.
But it bothered me in a way where it's like, I'm perplexed. I did that. So they were asking the question, and I think they were framing it like, which was a better couple, Martin and Gina or Jay and Michael? From My Wife and Kids, mm-hmm, or Martin, mm-hmm, and Gina from Martin. Mm-hmm. But I guess who was the better comedy duo? Was it Martin and Gina, or was it Michael and Jay from My Wife and Kids?
Ooh, I think My Wife and Kids.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot more to work with. There was a lot going on with the kids, especially the damn peanut head son. Mm. So
Junior.
So I think that one for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's why you got a dog in this fight?
The better duo to me was Martin and Gina.
Okay, why?
I guess I'll say it's bias on this one. Really, real talk. Because I I grew up watching Martin before I hopped on the My Wife and Kids series. I will say this, though. When it comes to her character, like, who should be the better man?
Like, Mike is the better man than Martin?
Martin
wasn't trash, was he?
He wasn't trash. I'm not saying Martin was trash. Love Martin to death.
Like a true 20-something.
Out of those two, I saw
somebody say Martin is the... I saw a girl say this on Twitter, and it went viral. Martin is the long-term boyfriend that you have when you're young, and then you break up, and then you meet your Michael.
Right.
Yeah.
I say that... I like Martin, but I think that Tisha Campbell was better as Jay because Damon Wayans gave her more room to play with.
Yeah.
And she learned some comedic skills from working on Martin. Mm-hmm. So she took what she did on Martin and brought it to My Wife and Kids and was a little bit more.
It up.
Yeah, she was able to have more room to dance with. I don't know. That was just some random.
That used to be so funny because I used to love seeing them almost break character laughing.
Yeah.
That joke used to have me on the ground.
So I don't know. They ain't had nothing to do with nothing. Nessa!
Yes.
Love him or leave him, dog. What is it? What you doing? Who we doing it with?
Love him or leave him is where you can write into me, Jerry and Vasco, and get unbiased relationship, situationship, or friendship advice. To write in, go to jerrythegreat.com. JerryThaGreat.com. Look for Love him or leave him. Click the link and let us know what's going on. Am I really breaking girl code? Bronx, New York. Hi, delinquents. I'm a frequent delinquent and play cousin. I really love the podcast. I need y'all's advice. Hope you guys can help me out. A couple years ago, my best friend, her baby father, and I used to have threesomes. Me and this girl are close. We have been best friends since high school and we are 30 now. I'm the godmother of birth of her kids and she's the godmother of my daughter. When I was unemployed, I lived with her for over a year. I babysat my godson and picked up my goddaughter from school so she could work. I was like the live-in nanny and girlfriend. We would mess around all together. When he came home for lunch or if he just came home before her, we would mess around if the kids were asleep or in another room. She knew about this. Her rules were he can't penetrate me without her. But everything else was okay. We haven't had a threesome in 2 or 3 years because I was in a serious thruple. A relationship with 3 equal partners. They just broke up maybe 3 months ago. Lately he has been in my DMs. I've been teasing him and playing with him. He wanted me to go with him to the telly. I'm single and he's single. Am I really breaking girl code if I fuck him? I mean, I already had him and it won't change my body count. I've been thinking about it. Or should I just leave him alone and tell her about the DMs? Listen, I need y'all's help. What would y'all do? Sign, I've been there and done that.
We're both of them. God damn.
Hey, cousin. Welcome. I like you. Let's be friends. Don't do that. You better fucking not do it. And you better not tell her. You need to tell her immediately. That's your best friend. Don't do it on some messy junk. Just be like, hey, just putting it in an atmosphere. Because at the end of the day, that's still her children's father. They're just letting you know, this is going on. I declined it. Or maybe you don't even say you declined it. They don't even say what your decision was yet. Just say, hey, just letting you know. And maybe see what she says. She might be like, oh, girl, go ahead. That don't make no difference to me. Or she might be like, I can't believe him. Da-da-da-da. You don't know how she's feeling about it. And that's your number one, I guess, obligation to the situation is to make sure that she's straight and that she's good with everything. So I'm not mad at you. Okay, we're here. But please check in with your girl. Please don't act. Go ahead and stop flirting with him in the DMs. Because that's going to look real messy whenever you do tell her. But if you stop it now, I feel like it's innocent enough considering y'all's past. But now you know. Don't do that shit. Let's go.
Hey, question for you, Vanessa, before Sco go.
Mm-hmm.
If the friend says it's okay, would you like
slide? Do it.
Okay.
Do it.
Hey man, I'm with Vanessa all the way on this, bro. Girl code, this is your best friend. Even if you was fucking on your best friend and her man's at the same time, doesn't matter. It's the principle. this is your girl's dude, baby daddy. You feel me? In that respect, you have to let her know, hey, dude, up in my DMs, I know you single. He's single. I'm single. Dude, in my DMs, man, and I just wanted to make sure it was cool with you if I go ahead and handle that. Now, either one or two things is going to happen. She going to hit you with a, yeah, go ahead. Or actually, one or three things. Yeah, go ahead. Two, no, nah, don't do that. That's still me. Or three, you remember what the rule was. So who knows? This could be a very happy ending for you. Or it could just be a normal ending. I'm not going to say a bad ending, but a normal one. Because your friend doesn't want you fucking on her person. Ex-person. You know what I mean? So just go ahead and get and just see if it's filled with water. See if that's cool. Is she cool with it? Hey, what'd she say? Slide.
Slide.
Slide. Go ahead. Get busy. Do your thing, man. If not, though, definitely take a step back, bro. Don't... I don't care what kind of past y'all had. I don't care if you think that it would be cool, bro. At the end of the day, no means no, bro. And you got to respect that if that really is your best friend. Yeah.
Oh, shit. I wasn't even ready.
Oh.
Well, just, I like what Vasco said. Just leave it open-ended. You know what I'm saying? Don't even say, I'm thinking about doing this or what do you think about me doing that? No. Just say, this is what happened and then see what she say.
Right.
Okay.
Hey, delinquents, what's up with you? You're a freaking delinquent and play cousin. You love the podcast. We love you back. And you need some advice. Hope you guys can help me out. Well, we're going to help you.
We're going to try.
This, I love this letter because this letter is so New York. This letter is so Bronx. This letter is so BK. I come from Bed-Stuy. What they either do or they don't not. This letter is so New York. Well, let me know that is when she said her baby father.
The baby father's part.
Baby father.
Yeah.
Because we down here where we say baby daddy.
Baby daddy.
I'm the godmother. Godmama down here. But yeah. I'm their godmother.
Mm-hmm. Come on, I know you got to say it for me, please.
The one that really got me was the telly.
The telly.
The telly.
Telly.
I thought that she was talking about the television.
Yeah.
I thought that telephone. She was talking about the telephone. She's talking about the hotel.
So she's not Britain.
No.
Not from London, England.
No. I just took a trip to the bodega.
It just goes to the bodega.
That's what it reminds me of. I don't know.
Goes to the bodega.
I don't know. I just love you because you so New York in this damn letter. So what's your problem? When you was unemployed, you know when you unemployed, you got a lot of time to fuck. I don't know if you know that. When you ain't got no money coming in, you can fuck your ass off. You was doing it too because you was not only fucking him but her and him. Together, them. Separately, them, and probably when you got bored and they wasn't there, you was probably fucking yourself, which is fine.
Prepare.
It's fine.
No. We were all messing around together, and then when he came home and the kids was in the other room sleep, you and him mess around, but y'all, the rule was he couldn't penetrate you without her. Did y'all really stick to that rule?
Thank you! I wanted to ask, bro.
Just be honest. That's going to tell you everything you need to know moving forward. Because that's the answer to your question. He can't penetrate me without her. That was her rule. If you abided by that rule, then I'm in agreement with Vanessa and Vasco. You need to go ahead and ask her, tell her what's going on, and then see what she say. But if there was a time
whoop, whoop, whoop.
While y'all was a throuple,
mm-mm.
And he penetrated you without her there, you already, I don't want to say an ain't shit friend, but you already scaved this friendship a little bit, right? You already done did it, and you been there, and you done that. What's going to be the difference of you doing it now again? The thought that you even thinking about it is letting me further know what you really want to do. The fact that it's a question. I'm not mad at you either way here because shit, y'all knew what it was before y'all got started. So that happens all the time in threesomes and throuples. Sometimes somebody end up going with another person and this, that, and the third. Now the fucked up part is that is your friend and you the godmother to her, both of her kids and you having these thoughts, but y'all in y'all 30s, y'all known each other since high school, so she'll forgive you. But you fuck around, you gonna fuck them. Don't get pregnant by them.
Yeah, bro.
Don't get pregnant by them. That's all I got. I know you're going to do it.
That's going to mess it up real.
That's going to really
fuck
it
up. And if you do, write us back.
Now your god, now your baby going to be her god babies.
Her sisters. Brothers and sisters.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Step, well,
yeah.
Damn, y'all really be family then. Mm-hmm.
Sis, don't do it.
I say do it. I normally wouldn't say content. Do it. For the content. Do it and write us back. Tell us what teller you went to. Did you go to the Hilton, the Hampton, the Hyatt?
Natalie.
tell us which one you went to. I say for the sake of content for this show, do it. Write us back.
Let us know what happened.
Yeah, let us know. Do it. Write us back.
I've been there.
It's my cousin right here. So I got to give her good advice.
You said that you would do it if the friend said, yeah.
The friend says, you know what I'm saying? Girl, I don't care about that. Then, yeah, do it. Why not?
What do you think the chances are of the friend saying that?
I think they're pretty good odds because they used to live together and they already used to do this thing. And now they're.
But as a throuple.
80%. Right. But now they're single. Yeah. Everybody's single, so.
But then, you think the friends be concerned about her catching emotions for her ex? Because bitch, we supposed to hate him together.
Maybe in like the traditional sense of, I guess, friendships and relationships and things like that. But if you got somebody that lived with another couple for a year, their mindset is a little different than this. Oh, bitch, if I don't like him, you don't like him either. You know what I'm saying? They're I think on a different. Frequency.
Honestly, I don't know about y'all. I've never been placed in this situation. I can't really fucking help you.
Yeah.
Cause I literally don't. Like you said, they got a whole different mindset. They got a whole different mindset. You feel me? Like, yeah. I can't relate to that frequency of thinking.
I done had friends who broke up with girls. I'm like, yeah, I don't care if you smash her. I done had friends who said that.
Mm-hmm. That did not care about you.
What, he didn't care about me?
No.
Oh, about the girl.
Yeah.
Maybe some of them said and they just like trying to show like they
didn't care.
Yeah, but they really did.
Yeah,
that's you go back and say, yeah, you know, I smashed the girl. You was right. She does have a mole right there.
That thing you told me she do all the time, but yeah, I ain't know that.
I didn't know she did it like that. I'm gonna kill you.
Right. Look,
how you talk about words that hurt earlier. Oh, I got something for your ass.
Oh, yeah, I do.
Meet me at the telly. So yeah, that's my advice for you. I wrote this note down. It's a little too late, isn't it? That was my note because you already did it.
Damn, bro.
Good luck. Tell your friend.
Tell your friend.
But this is the thing, and it's my last thing. I promise, Vanessa.
It's okay.
You flirting with this dude already in the DM. So what you right. gonna what no, you gonna tell the friend?
Already wrong.
Yeah.
But it's what's wronger? Shit, stop it right now. It's I feel like it's a little bit understandable right now. Like y'all have sexual chemistry. Why not? You know what I'm saying? Flirt a little bit, but flirting and fucking is two different things.
Yeah.
It's easier to ask for forgiveness than it is permission.
That is true too. I live by that.
So
red flag.
Good luck to you, sister. to your play cousin. Good luck to you.
The brother, the sister, the friend. Newark, New Jersey. Hello. That's how they put it. I love the pod and blessings all around. Anyways, my older brother, 24, and I, 23, moved out in the midst of COVID. We were both working and collecting unemployment, making it easy to get out and snag a nice crib. We've been living together almost a year now, and the only real change from living with our mom and five siblings is I see a lot of his friends more often. My brother and I are best friends, two peas in a pod, the Kilawa to my gone.
Yes, sir. Okay.
And with that, he's really overprotective when it comes to me, but he's also the sweetest guy you'll ever meet, which is probably why he's been letting one of his closest friends stay with us, which I don't mind. He contributes to the rent, food, and keeps it out of the way, and he's tidy. Now, my brother travels for work a lot. He's a truck driver and could be gone for days at a time. So when his friend isn't sleeping on the couch, he's in my brother's room. All that time with the two of us in the crib has really given us a lot of time to get closer. To the point where we share shows together, we have gone out on a couple nights, and as much as we tried to keep it strictly friendship, like I knew my brother would like, it obviously didn't happen. TV nights and nights out have all turned into nights with one hand on my frontal, if you catch my drift. My brother says when he's home, he has been clocking the weird way his friend's been looking at me and doesn't like it. I had to lie and reassure him nothing was going on, and he believed me because I know my nigga wouldn't do no shit like that. It's now been 3 months of us hiding the fact that we've basically been dating. Did I mess up by not already telling him and lying for so long? A three-bedroom opened up in our building and my brother wants to take it for the three of us, but I feel like before we should do that, I should come clean. Any advice would really help. I don't want my brother mad at me or to lose his friend. Help a cousin out. Sign, my brother's best friend is my lover. Girl, I'm grown, you grown, we grown, he grown. Tell this man what's going on. Tell your brother. You should have told him a long time ago. I guess I really don't get this complex because I got a baby brother and I got an older sister. So I can tell, you know, sister to sister, you can tell your sister anything, and he's my baby brother, I could tell him anything. So it's strange to me, I guess, when siblings are like so close, but I can't tell him that. Like, why? He'll be fine. He'll be okay. And then what's gonna happen? He's gonna be mad at you and him for a little bit, and then guess what? He'll get over it and he'll be okay. If y'all's relationship is really that strong, which it sounds like, and I love that. So I think, yes, come clean to brother. Maybe don't tell him it's been 3 months. Maybe tell him y'all went out one time together, something like that. So stretch the truth a little bit. That's my advice. I don't know. But girl, tell that man. Tell your brother what's up.
Tell him what's up. But best believe he finna be pissed. Oh, he finna be mad, boy, at you, and especially at dude. And I don't know how close him and dude really is.
But he's sleeping in his room.
Off rip with that comment. I know my nigga never do no shit like that to me. To me.
You thought.
But yeah, when he find out, he gonna be very upset. He probably gonna have a few choice words for his homie. He gonna say something to you out of pocket, like, you can't talk to her no more, y'all better not, blah 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 blah. But like Vanessa said, bro, y'all grown. You can do whatever you want at the end of the day. Best believe you done fucked up already, though. It's been three months. And you ain't told, bro, that y'all done went on a date. Y'all done had movie nights. He gonna be upset. He will get over it. That's not the point. Own up to the fuck up first. Tell them the whole truth so that you can go ahead and be out there. And then what happens afterwards, you can't, and you shouldn't have no guilty conscience over. You done spoke your truth as all you could do. Told your brother what the fuck was up, and he gonna appreciate that. He's still gonna be pissed, but he gonna appreciate it. Then you can continue to live your life. You and this friend, do y'all really like each other? This is a question I need answered. I'm for real. Let me tell you something. I got a theory. If you put two motherfuckers in a room for a long enough time, they will eventually fall in love with each other.
They ain't held hostage in that motherfucker.
I'm just saying, no. But I'm just saying, if you do that, they will eventually start to catch some type of feelings for each other. And that's what I feel like happened here. The best friend would just happen to be around. You live there too. Now we spend the time together. They go from, okay, yeah, we would never. To that, oh, okay, you get that one look. Oh, you look kind of good tonight. He do the same thing. Oh, you look kind of good tonight. Next week, go on. Damn, I'm gonna go ahead and try to make a move.
So you saying, is it a matter of convenience?
That's all it was. So now I'm just trying to, if you have a genuine relationship with bro now that you're trying to cultivate and work on, go for it. Go ahead. But really ask yourself, is it the convenience that you was paying for because it was just accessible, or do you really like, man? And you need to really let your brother know which one it was. If he was just, you know what I'm saying, a little F toy, or if he was actually somebody you could see yourself being with, because that definitely will ease the blow. Honestly, either way direction it go. Tell him the truth. Tell your brother the truth. Jerry.
I'm trying to find, because most of these letters have like a little hidden key point. This one doesn't. I think that you have a good point with asking that question of, is it convenience? That's a great question. But I don't see it being convenient in this letter. And I'm going to tell you why once I get to that point. So your brother's 23. Your older brother's 24. You're 23, female. And in the midst of COVID, y'all moved in together. You and your brother's are two peas in a pod. And you like this pod. Thank you. So big family. Mom, you know, mom has five kids. Y'all was all staying there. So shit, your mom got seven kids. That's not like my family, so I can relate to you even more. Okay, here we go. I don't know. I can't relate to you with the killer, with the killer loo to the gun. I couldn't relate to you with that.
Kilua.
Your brother has a big heart. He's one of the sweetest guys you'll ever meet, and that's probably why he let his best friend stay with y'all. He contributes. The best friend contributes to rent, food, and keeps himself out the way, and he is tidy. Your brother travels a lot. He's a truck driver. Last week. So y'all did spend a lot of time in the house together, just the two of y'all in the crib. But like I said, it wasn't, you weren't held there hostage. I think the line that really pulls me in this one is that your brother thinks this about your friend. I know my nigga wouldn't do me like that. Now, I'm going to say this statement. I'm going to try to be a little poetic. As poetic as I possibly can, but ride with me a little bit. I don't think, and I'm just speaking in general, I don't think that your brother's friend is the most attractive guy. I don't think so. And the reason why I'm thinking that is because I don't think that your brother saw in his best friend and his sister a connection that could be happening. Now, I think that you might be a very attractive lady. I don't think that the friend might not be that attractive. So the brother wasn't worried about that. Yeah, my friend can stay. My sister ain't got no... I've seen the dudes my sister used to talk to before. She ain't got no interest in Luke. Yeah, Luke can stay. She and Annie, my brother type. It's not a threat. It's not a worry. It's not nothing that I need to be worried about while I'm out here driving trucks. And he can be a protector for my sister who's at the house by herself. Or it could be vice versa. It could be vice versa where my sister ain't Luke's type. Mm-hmm. I know Luke all this time. I know the kind of girls he like. And he can be a protector while he's there, but he's also not going for my sister. But the line that threw me off and that fucked me up was your brother said when he noticed that his friend was looking at you kind of, you know, like, ooh, look at the booty out in his pants. I know my nigga wouldn't do no shit like that to me. That's a dangerous line. That's a very, very dangerous line. That line reminds me of Scarface. I don't know if you ever seen the movie Scarface. Tony Montana, Alejandro, and Gina. Gina Montana. Gina was Tony Montana's sister. Tony Montana was very protective of his sister Gina. If you never seen the movie Scarface, go watch it.
He told him.
Scarface's best friend was Alejandro. They killed together. They sold dope together. They made millions together. That was his ride or die, his ace bone coon, as the old folks called it. Alejandro had a thing for Gina.
Mm-mm.
Tony Montana was very protective over Gina, like you say your brother is over you. Tony Montana came home, went to Alejandro's house. Alejandro opened the door. Gina was coming downstairs in a robe with a little titties hanging out. And without asking a question, without getting a answer, without even saying what the fuck is going on, Tony Montana shot and killed his best friend. Now, I'm not saying that your brother gonna go that damn far.
Mm-hmm.
But this line, I know my nigga wouldn't do no shit like that. Yeah. So, of course, I'm not saying that you should keep this secret from your brother cousin. But before y'all think about this damn three bedroom, maybe you and him need to be talking about a two together, and then a one bedroom for your brother. Don't leave your brother in this mess, in this world of confusion. Cause it's gonna only get y'all gonna only get messier, and not in the sense of like y'all gonna get looser. You and the guy that you got a thing for, y'all gonna get messier. Y'all gonna be in the kitchen cooking together. He gonna smack you in your ass, and your brother gonna come around the corner like, what was that? You know what I mean? It's gonna only get messier. Y'all gonna be he gonna be in the kissing you. And then your brother gonna walk around and see like, oh, what's that? What? It's gonna y'all bound to get caught in the same place. It's bound to happen. So I would say your brother may be okay with you. Like once you tell him, your brother may be okay with you, but he might not fuck with the friend no more.
No, I was over thinking the same thing.
Your brother might not fuck with the friend no more. So that might be the only negative. Your brother gonna be mad at you for a little bit, but he's really not gonna believe that his best friend, who's not his blood, but he kind of treated him like he was the blood, who he let move into his house, was one lying to him about everything that's going on between you and him. Your brother gonna be pissed off about that, because if you lied about that, what else would you lie about? That, and then you betray my trust. You like a brother to me, but you fucking my sister, nigga. What? He can't see that right now. Early on, he won't. Now, I'm not saying 5 years from now he won't be the best man at y'all wedding. It could happen, but I'm saying right now in this sense, it's better for you to tell him sooner than to tell him later. Because if you wait anymore, Alejandro. So, yeah. My brother's best friend is my lover. Your brother's best friend gonna get fucked up.
That nigga green, bro.
You the best friend?
Yes.
I didn't even talk about the best friend. Now the best friend is in the wrong too.
No, that nigga green.
The best friend is in the wrong too, because the best friend probably should have, you know, like, hey, whoa, that's my dog.
Yeah.
And you know, like, I'm fucking with you. I want this to work, but I need my dog's blessing. You don't play in nobody's backyard without letting them know that you back there playing in their backyard.
But like, only the best friend is that wrong here. Yeah. I don't feel like sis is that wrong.
No, she wrong for not saying nothing.
She don't need to tell her brother her grown woman business.
3 months.
What dude, you right. You got a point.
That's her business.
But it's her best. But it's her brother's best friend.
Yeah. So best friend.
So collectively, they probably should tell. Like, they should come together. No, I'm not saying send the best friend in by itself. Have your brother come in. Hey, have a seat. We got something we want to tell you. Because then he gonna say, "What? You pregnant? No."
He'll sit down, but have a seat.
Bitch, no, y'all need to go out to the park.
Yeah.
So
you gotta have your motherfucking running shoes.
Be ready,
on.
Yeah.
And you know your brother better than we do. If your brother got a short fuse, yeah, go to the park, get in front of some people.
He got that bit loaded in the back.
Yeah. Go get some people. You what? I'll be right back, you sons of bitches.
Where the fuck is he?
So good luck to you. Vanessa, you got anything you want to tag before you close the segment?
No.
Like, okay, well, shit, close your segment.
Oh, okay, my bad. I don't know if you want to. Anyway,
Gasco got anything to say?
No.
Okay. Good luck to you, cuz. Write us back, let us know how it go. Tell them, write us back, let us know how it go.
Yeah, Love Them or Leave Them is where you can write into me, Jerry Vasco. Get unbiased relationship, situationship, or friendship advice. Go to jerrythegreat.com, look for Love Them or Leave Them, click the link, and send us some info.
There you go, Vasco!
Yo.
Vasco!
Yo, Jay Jerry.
What's going on in Florida this week, man?
Oh, me?
Mm-hmm.
Shit, we can get into it. Hey, I got a question for you.
Uh-huh.
What if your other half got killed? I.e. your girlfriend, wife, boyfriend, or husband, for the people watching. What if your other half got killed?
Shit, ask Vanessa, too. Shit, don't just ask me.
No,
Right.
Yeah.
You'd be shocked. Be a little hurt. Nah. What if you found out that the person, or the individual, I should say, that killed your other half was your own 2-year-old kid?
Mm.
Ladies and gentlemen, today on What the Florida, we have father of toddler who found gun in Paw Patrol backpack and shot dead mother on Zoom call is arrested. We'll talk about more.
What the Florida is going on here? Did you hear what I said?
And you already know what I said because you heard what I said. Father of toddler who found a gun in his Paw Patrol backpack, shot and killed his mother dead on a Zoom call. He's now arrested. We'll talk about it more, but first, roll the intro.
I don't care what part of Florida it is. The craziest people in all of America are in the Bronx in Florida.
It's distilled. It's just like, it's pure. It's 100% so uncut stuff. Florida fuckery.
Yo, what it is, what it do, man. It's your boy, Sko. And check it. On What the Florida, we have founder of toddler who found gun in Paw Patrol backpack and shot dead mother on Zoom call is arrested. Before I start this, I do want to go ahead and say we pray for both the Lynn and the Avery families. As we understand, they're going through this difficult time. We just wanted to go ahead and say that. But now let's go ahead and get into this. A Florida man whose 2-year-old son fatally shot his mother during a video call has been arrested for failing to keep the gun out of the child's reach. Viondre Avery, 22, appeared in court on Wednesday, a day after he was arrested on charges of manslaughter and failure to secure a weapon. On August 11th, 21-year-old Shamaya Lynn was on a Zoom work call at her residence in Altamonte Springs. When her co-worker on the other side of the call heard a loud gunshot and saw Lynn's 2-year-old son standing in the background, Lynn immediately fell off her seat and did not respond to her co-worker's attempt to reach her. The co-worker then decided to contact 911, and I quote, "One of the girls passed out. She was bleeding. She has the camera on. Her baby is crying in the back." The coworker said this to emergency calls, according to the Orlando Sentinel. Lynn was shot in the head by the toddler, who was alone at home with his mother that day. After examining the forensic evidence, the police said it was, and I quote, clearly established that the son discovered the gun and shot his mother on his own will without any external help. Mr. Avery, after returning home, also contacted emergency services, begging them to, and I quote, please hurry. The police said that when they arrived, Mr. Avery was making desperate attempts to revive his girlfriend. However, Lynn was already pronounced dead shortly after. Since the gun belonged to Mr. Avery and he had left it unsecured, loaded, and without the safety on, he has been charged for neglect and manslaughter. Cases of accidental shootings by children rose in the U.S. during the pandemic. Recent studies show, according to research by the advocacy group Every Town for Gun Safety, 128 deaths were reported from unintentional shootings by children between March and December 2020, a 31% increase from the same period in 2019. Now, I know this is a downer, ladies and gentlemen, but
let's talk about this. What's going on?
Yeah, I was
going
to say it's leading up. So let's go ahead and talk about this story, man. The first question I want to ask y'all. How do y'all think the father feels?
Awful. I think it was like an innocent mistake. In the climate we live in, it's not outrageous to have a firearm in your home. And then, you know, really you should have it locked away. But if somebody's breaking in your home, if your firearm is locked away, then so, yeah. And my boyfriend carries, and sometimes he just has it out. We don't have any children in our home, but every once in a while, especially when I saw this story, I was like, dang, I need to talk to him about, you know, being in a habit of not leaving it out, because God forbid, you know, a couple years from now we have kids and something like this happens. I feel like it could happen kind of like every day. So I feel like he feels like shit. It's an unfortunate situation.
My gun is away, but it's not locked or anything. So if someone was to roam and find it, like even when my cousin was spending the night, we were out of town. My cousin was watching my house, and she had her kids here. I had a thought like, oh shit, I hope that they're not in my room, because if they find that shit, ooh. So I had to text her like, hey, I got that thing over there. So don't let them kids go in there and see that. But now I'm looking to get a safety lock box, but it's more so like a safety lock box that's like a fingerprint. Mm. Mm.
Okay.
So that way ain't no combination, bitch.
It's only me.
And then in it, I'm gonna have that bitch cocked, loaded, and ready to go. Mm. So I ain't gotta fumble around with it. So that's what I'm doing. Just because I got nieces and nephews who be in my house a lot. Auntie, and I fall asleep when I babysit. So
this bad,
auntie, uncle, what's this? And I wake up and you gotta point it at me. Oh shit. Put it down.
Whatever you want.
I'll get you the gummies. Wow. I get you the juicy juice. Just put the
popsicles. Look, man. Another one that was really pondering for me is, obviously this kid is gonna continue to grow up.
Mm-hmm.
How do you think they react once they get to that certain point where it's like I can understand the repercussions of what I've done?
I think at two, I don't know what their memory will be of it. I think that it's gonna be important what the people around that kid tells that kid. So why is daddy in jail? I think it's important what you're gonna say. I don't think that you wanna tell the 6-year old, where's my mommy? Oh, you killed her.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I don't think that you want to say that. Why is daddy in jail? Oh, because you killed your mama. And if daddy, so I think that it's important for the parents to kind of walk around. Not the parents.
Guardian.
The guardians and family members and people who know what's going on around the situation to walk around it. But I do also think that a 2-year-old has some sort of a memory or some kind of traumatic experience. They're going to be put in some kind of counseling, and they're going to understand like what they did. And I think that could mentally fuck somebody up in the long run. So I think that this kid into adulthood is going to be going through a lifelong life of trauma and therapy and working through shit and trying to figure out shit and trying to forgive themselves for the unknowns that they did as a kid. So
does daddy deserve to be in jail for this?
That's a tough question. Does the drug dealer who sold you the drugs need to be in jail if you overdose? That's kind of what I thought about.
That's a good question.
I don't think that's comparable.
Maybe not. I don't, and I, it so, might not be. Yeah. But
I mean, I do see, which, yes, the link.
You know what I mean? But it's not comparable, but.
Yeah. Now, it is a tough question because I don't even know how to answer it myself.
Why was it in a Paw Patrol bag, I guess, is my next question.
Because who's going to think to look in a Paw Patrol bag?
Besides the Except
for besides the kid. Right. Obviously, the kid, he ain't think that last little part.
Yeah.
But definitely not a burglar or anything.
And then why was it, I guess this is a question too, why was it loaded and ready to fire? Yeah. Unless
who got time to put bullets in?
In the words of Vasco, they're in Altamonte Springs. Altamonte Springs. and Altamonte Springs has its pockets of, you know, hey, don't go over there. So unless they're in one of them areas of like, hey, don't go over there, that makes sense where that thing need to be cocked and loaded and ready to go because shit, you never know.
So where does the issue lie? Are we going to say that this is a parental awareness issue or are we going to say this is a gun awareness?
Both.
You go through training and stuff to get, and I'm assuming it's licensed to him, or it would. I feel like the charges would be worse. And
if it wasn't his gun, yeah.
They tell you what to do, what not to do, and I'm pretty sure hiding in the backpack, is not on the things to do list. But I can see why he had it that way. You know. Put myself in his shoes. I can see.
I'm just trying to,
the Paw Patrol backpack part. That's the only part.
Now I'm thinking you probably was doing something you had no business doing. That bit was hot, or you was trying to put it up real quick.
You ain't never hid your cereal in a place that you're like, oh, no one's gonna look here.
I ain't gonna lie to you, Vanessa.
You don't hide your cereal. Okay, all right.
Well, I keep my cereal in the pantry, but if I had to hide it.
I've definitely tried to hide it some places where I'm like, nobody would look in there. But if I had a 2-year-old walking around my house, maybe I put it in a shoe or something like that. 2-year-olds pick up shoes and try to put on shoes all the time.
What is this? Put it down.
Is it a, I don't know, man. I know this is one of the what the Floridas that's kind of like, because it was either this or the teacher that was pregnant by the 15-year-old. So I was like, let's go here. So I don't know, like.
At least this could spread some awareness.
Yeah.
So if you have a firearm at home.
That's what I really wanted to drive home was.
Double check it.
Make sure see that you put safety on.
Yeah. If you get a lockbox if you can. That's my biggest suggestion. So my gun, it's not cocked and loaded, but it's one, maybe two steps for me to cock and load it.
Ain't gonna be long.
Ain't gonna be long.
Ready? Yeah.
I hear noise. Uh oh, there you go. That's just that many. So
I've seen a situation where a kid has, like at a family function, a kid has gotten into like some edibles or something, and the kid brought it downstairs, but they were like 30 seconds away
from eating it.
And then who knows? And then now the person who brought the edibles would have been in jail. Mm-hmm. The person who the mama would have been, you know what I'm saying? So it would just been this whole mess. But does that person who brought the edibles deserve to be in jail? Yeah. So it's
same thing with pills though. Like
it makes me think of
kids getting into pills and you eating the pills and it's like, oh shit. Like
that's just legalized drugs.
That's my ibuprofen that I had because I had back pain, but I didn't think that your ass was going to jump on the counter.
And chew all these over.
I was passed the fuck out from these damn pain pills that the doctor put me on. Now I'm in jail because I did what the doctor told me to do and you was down for a nap. Now you done woke up and you was being nosy.
Doing something you had no business doing.
Yeah, so
I got caught up.
Yeah.
Shit happens.
Shit happens, bro. Make sure y'all be safe. Make sure you keep your eyes on your kids. And if you have a firearm, please do the necessary steps in order to take precautions. I am Vasco Man, a.k.a. I am.VSJ, and that has been With the Florida Folk.
I don't care what part of Florida it is, the craziest people in all of America are in the Bronx and Florida.
That's distilled. It's just like, it's pure. It's 100% so uncut Florida fuckery.
Welcome back. I had to wake some people up. I know y'all get this far into the motherfucking video. Some of y'all like to, you know what I'm saying, hop off, but.
Nah, they been this bitch late as hell.
Deep.
Sit your ass right here.
And deep, too. Deep and late. Late and deep. They been showing out, though, in the.
In the comment.
Well, just like watching. I was like, damn, all these motherfuckers watching for real? I was surprised.
It takes. You got to go all the way back to like 4 months, I believe. Like early 4 months, just to see one of our videos that hasn't hit. Like a band in views.
I don't know if it's 4 months. It's probably a little quicker than that, but.
Well,
I appreciate you stretching it.
Can with all the three of us. 1,000 in reference to something
On YouTube?
No, because he said a band. So just like keep me hip. Because usually I thought a band just meant for money. But anything that's a thousand or more,
yeah,
I can say band too.
Yeah.
Or a yard is 100.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I thought that you would know that.
Locking that in.
Mrs. Westside. Westside of Jacksonville. Westside.
I'll take my glasses off. It's cooler.
Because you're cool with your glasses on.
Yeah. I got new glasses. Y'all don't even notice.
Did you know?
Y'all don't even say nothing.
Vanessa,
let me see. Hold
Vanessa,
on.
We see you one day after okay. week.
No, me and some new friends.
Oh, thank you.
They is hard. Okay, okay. I see. I see.
What color you? Nigga, what? Shit. I think that's my wife by the time. And then she look at me crazy, too. What the fuck you thought I was going to do to you?
Shit. Oh, I just got these.
Okay, and? The fuck?
Now I'm keeping them all.
My wife be doing that to me like, I'm like, what the fuck
are
you?
Neck hurts.
The fuck? Can somebody bring me in for my segment, please? I'm sorry. I was trying to. Vasco went to his phone.
I didn't know.
No, that was, yeah, Vasco went to his phone. Vasco's going to bring me in. But
I got you. I got you.
I saw
you.
He had dipped.
Watch this.
Huh?
No, I'm saying watch you. Watch this.
Watch
this? Yeah, go.
Jay!
Yeah.
Vasco!
Jay!
Let's go!
Jay!
Let's go!
Raise it up.
Damn, how many was that? There goes it.
I was just trying to get you.
Half, yeah.
Yeah, I was just trying. Okay. Yeah, you feel me? Just trying to bring you on in for the top five.
Well, here we go, good brother. Top five.
Top
five. At the tippy top. We at the tippy top. Top five. Here we go.
Tell me how you really feel. Tell me how you really feel. Top five. Top five. Top five.
Yep, it's your boy Jared the Great, and my top five today, y'all. Y'all know we got this sponsor.
Mm-hmm.
Out of bounds. I just bent this shit all the fuck up.
Out of bounds.
I was gonna say, this is not what the box looks like.
This is not. It's a nice box. Out of bounds. They gave us a shout out recently, so I was like, hey, let's play another round.
Okay.
Let's play another round.
Okay.
So this time it's gonna be me to y'all.
Oh shit.
Y'all ready? So we gonna see, because I like when y'all go toe to toe with each other, because it'd be interesting to see who gonna win it.
Score.
You know what I'm thinking about, bro?
What?
I'm thinking about fucking Squid Game right now.
Oh yeah. The player who loses will be eliminated. The player who loses will be eliminated. So I got these words right here. So the way Out of Bounds work, it's the black taboo. It's for the culture. So for an example, this word right here, the word in the middle is Malcolm X. So I have to use words to describe that without using these words on the outside. Now, we had a team of four. So when we stand it over my shoulder, and if I said one of these words on the outside, they would say Out of bounds. Mm-hmm. And then that card would be invalid. But because it's just the three of us, we are going to play like this, and we're going to have the trust system that Jerry. That's what my friend.
Integrity.
Integrity.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go. Three so, you ready? And go. It's old Vanessa. You drive one of these. Someone might say you drive one of these.
A Kia?
No, it's a car.
Hootie?
There you go.
Okay. Fuck you, and I don't.
Okay, here we go. This is a kids game. It has numbers, and you hop and
hopscotch.
You, there you go, Vanessa. Damn. Okay. So Sunday morning you're getting ready for church. Your mama gotta do this, and you gotta say, wash my neck, wash the neck.
Vanessa, curl your hair, Vanessa, flat iron,
okay, you probably want to do this.
Comb. God damn it!
It's
straight iron.
You put it
hot
on.
Comb.
There you go. Okay, I'm gonna say you put it on the outer stove. I don't know what the hell that is. Okay, so there was a movie with Taraji P. Henson, Terrence Howard.
Skip that one because I seen the card. It's Hustle.
Okay, well damn.
See, integrity.
There you go. Vasco was rapping this song the other week, and we was like, damn, you know that song from that group?
Shut up. Wu-Tang.
Clan.
No. They're
NWA.
Okay, so who was the main writer of that group?
Ice Cube.
There you go, good brother. Ice Cube.
Okay, that's one.
All right. Jeezy. Oh, shit, damn. Jeezy was on this song, him and another guy who we later had beef with. It was one of Jeezy's first songs. All the girls were excited. Ooh, they know you liked it.
Gucci Mane, I'm so icy.
What's the last word?
Also, I see.
There you go. Okay. All right. This is a TV show coming back to TV soon in their fifth and final season.
Boondocks.
Fifth and final season.
Fifth and final.
Yep. You have a friend. You have. I can say his name. Lawrence is on that show.
Okay. Insecure.
There you go. All right.
5-1. Come on. Talk to me.
Okay, this is the last one.
Okay, one more shit. Look, here we
go. This is what happens whenever you black people do this all the time.
Complain.
You go to Big Mama house.
Sleep.
No, you go to Big Mama house for Sunday dinner. And then what happens soon as you get that Sunday dinner in your system? What you do?
Sleep, eat, leave.
What they call
the
that?
Itis.
There you go.
Okay, very good. Yeah. Okay. Buzzer 2 to 5.
I'll take a buzzer beater though.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, last I feel one. Like I should get an extra one.
Last one. Here we go. This guy won a Grammy and an Oscar for the song Gold Digger, and he had a show.
Jay-Z.
He had a show that was a really fancy show. He won a Grammy and an Oscar.
50 Cent.
Okay, who won a Grammy and an Oscar for playing Ray?
Jay Fox.
Okay, what was the name of the show?
Jamie Foxx show.
There you go, Vanessa.
Oh, okay.
All right. There we go. Last one, I promise.
This okay.
Okay. Now, damn. Did y'all hear what I said? Okay. Okay. So everybody needs to get into this. Okay. Now let's get in
to it.
Okay, now let's get into
it.
She performed at the Super Bowl. Black Panther, where everybody went crazy.
Beyonce.
But what song?
Okay, let's get into it.
Okay, let's get into
Formation.
There you go, Vasco.
Okay, that was good, Scott.
Damn.
All
right, I'm in this. I wore the shirt last week.
Kappa,
I got some
ABCU.
I got some good brothers. What are they, though? Kappa. What do you call that?
Noobs.
No, fraternity. What do you call the... There you go, Vasco. Oh, okay. Damn, Vanessa, you had it.
I'm sorry, I was getting too...
If you used to watch 106 in Park, every Friday they did this.
Freestyle Friday?
Yeah, Freestyle, there you go.
There you go.
Dougie.
E.
Dougie.
Fresh.
There you go, Vasco.
What? I gave him that!
Dark Skin Unveil, Light Skin Unveil was on what show?
Fresh Prince.
Okay. It's a hood classic. Ezell just passed away.
Friday,
man.
Fuck. That's Vanessa. If you can eat, you can eat shrimp like this.
Forrest Gump.
No. it can be lied, died, or laid to the side. What's the first word?
Lied.
Fried.
Vanessa got it. Okay. For Us by Us.
Fubu.
Mm-hmm. She couldn't dug it. She tried to dug it. Looked dumb as hell when she did it. She got medals.
Simone Biles.
The other black girl. She tried to dug it. She looked stupid as fuck when she tried.
Not Venus, not Serena.
Okay, we gonna pass that one. All right, here we go. Last one, I promise, because I don't know what this one is. Oh, shit. It's The Rock.
The Rock.
It's crazy.
Jadakiss.
Marcy Projects.
Wait, how is it? And it's not Jadakiss.
It's not. Oh no, I guess Jadakiss does do that. Shit. I be on my suit and tie shit.
Justin Timberlake.
But who was on that song with him?
Timberland.
Who else was on the song?
No.
I be on my shooting time shit.
Who else was on the song with Justin Timberlake?
Yeah, I don't know.
Stop doing that! Shut up!
Yeah, it's crazy. It's mad crazy right now.
Fabulous.
Who?
Fabulous?
No. It's mad crazy right now.
Jay-Z?
There you go.
Okay. Wait a minute.
You did not say Jay-Z.
You did not say Jay-Z.
Quiet. Now the score is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 11. I could have just counted it like that, but I'm going to count it all the way out. And then to 5.
Bam, Fiasco. Well, that's the game out of bounds, folks. Make sure that you go get that game. Use the code word "identify the linkers" in our bio. Go get that game, and then let us know that you got it. And then play that at your next family function. But that was my top 5.
Tell me how you really feel. Tell me how you really feel.
What?
Top 5.
Was my Jay-Z impression bad?
Yeah.
I couldn't say Hova.
That was because
I was on the words.
No.
Yeah. It's The Rock.
Yeah,
throw The Rock sign because the Deltas and all of them had a whole beef with Jay-Z for that.
This is not this what they want it to be. That's the Jay-Z sign.
Mm-hmm.
That's the me.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Well, since you're throwing up the mid. Nessa!
Yes.
Fast go!
Yo.
It's time to go!
It is.
But before we do, women want to know.
Ooh, that was good. It's like a part that? Of the show.
Uh-huh. Me too.
She, all right. I know.
She's been rhyming all day.
Nessa! Well, Nessa got glasses and chains on her finger, bud.
Nessa's slow a little bit.
All right. Y'all know I'm the only one you that's sipping a little bit.
So she just left like Ray Charles?
That's what we do with glasses.
She just left like Ray Charles. Well, it's the hummingbirds, B.
Anyway.
Women want to know, dog, what's going on this week? Because y'all always want to know. I say what women want to know. A lot of women want y'all to do another ladies' night, and I'm like, God damn.
Yes, let's do it.
We'll talk about it. What women want to know this week?
Women want to know is a little bit different this week. Because I'm in a situation, and I need some advice from you guys. So what are some suggestions for women in power or women in authoritative positions that men have to kind of either answer to or take direction from? Because I'm getting some friction. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm in a small position, you know, of power, just real small, but I still have to work with a lot more males than I'm used to. Mm-hmm. And I'm going through situations like somebody trying to hit on me. I had somebody fuss with me about a cooler. I had somebody kind of bow up at me and like talk
bow up, huh?
Like,
so when he didn't
like what I was saying, he kind of like, his voice got louder. He started kind of talking over me.
What he said?
Oh, he wanted to get a little stern.
Well, that's not what happened. Because I said, well, do you normally pick them up at this time? No, I always pick them up at the right time. And in my mind, I wanted to be like, well, no, you don't. But in the situation, I was like, well, maybe that's not going to be the best thing. Right. So I didn't say anything. I was just like, oh, okay. But then he kept kind of growing, and so I didn't really know how to handle that situation. I just did what I normally do. I was just like, oh, okay. So I'm asking you guys as men, because I don't know if y'all realize y'all do kind of treat women in positions of power just a smidge bit different.
I'm gonna say I don't. Okay. Just from the fact that all of my supervisors prior to where I'm at now have all been women.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you haven't had a male supervisor yet, except for the one you're working with for now?
If I'm thinking real quick, no.
Wow.
Yeah.
Awesome.
All women, yeah.
I love that. Mm-hmm. So do you see your relationship with your current boss different than your...
Same.
The dynamic is the same? The way y'all talk to each other is the same and everything?
Mm-hmm. We talk about different things, like more so sports.
Mm-hmm.
But, and man stuff, like, you know, but...
What's man stuff?
Like in my interview, I made a joke because one of the questions was, what's one of your strongest skills or something like that? And or something, it was something like that. And I made a joke. I was like, well, I would say communication, but my wife would disagree. And it was very funny. So
that is a man joke.
That's a man joke. Right. But I don't think
a woman in an interview would say, well, my husband.
Would you
reference your husband in an interview?
If
they bring up family, but the way he just did it, would you do something like that? Probably.
But I also look at interviews like, you know, I got 10 minutes to perform a set, so I'm gonna get you to like me in these 10 minutes. So I'm gonna tell the jokes that I know that's gonna work over in this room.
That's interesting. Yeah. Women in the comments, I'm curious, if you're in an interview, if the question is not specific about family, are you bringing up your significant other or your husband?
If you can slide him in there and it's funny and it's tasteful, because that was very tasteful and funny.
If it's like a name drop, like if somebody asks about your hobbies, you can like talk about that, or yeah, like, oh, we do this together.
Mm-hmm.
And then they kind of like slides in there, and then it opens the conversation. Say, oh, well, tell me about your family.
Yeah. Okay.
But to your question though, I guess I'll be honest. I had two female supervisors who I had a lot of friction with, but the reason why I had friction with them is because they were supervising me to do a job that they couldn't do or didn't know anything about. So my biggest issue with them was, how are you going to tell me how to do my job when you can't even do the basics of my job? So the reason you're telling me, no, I can't do this, is because of your personal. Mm-hmm. It's not because of this is the right thing to do, this is the wrong thing to do. Mm-hmm. It's because you personally just want to say no.
Yeah.
No, we don't want to make. I don't want to make those.
So they were like abusing their power.
Yeah, but okay. You know, but in the same, I treat shit. Hell, you can fire me tomorrow, today. I'm gonna respect you.
Mm-hmm.
Man, woman, cat, dog, them, they.
Okay.
Well,
in my experience in dealing with female supervisors or women in power, I always treat them with respect. But the one thing that I think, to help your question, that you could take away from them, mm-hmm. I've never seen you in action, mm-hmm. so this is literally just me speaking. I've noticed that they are very strong.
Like,
they don't, like, they know that they in a position of power, but they won't just keep constantly reminding you, like, yeah, I'm the fucking boss. It's just they carry themselves like, I'm the boss. Treat me with respect. And then when I do end up like interacting or talking with them, it's always professional. But the thing I do appreciate is the fact that they can come back down to earth though and just be like,
mm-hmm.
and just talk and just kick it with me. But then at a certain point, it's like, all right, motherfucker, go hop on the register, run a rack. Go.
Vanessa, for you, this is a question for you. Do you, because to Vesco's point, oftentimes, unfortunately, and men and women, I've seen this in my experiences working, whenever there's a woman in charge, they get called the B word, the bitch. She's such a mm-hmm. bitch. But why are women called bitches when they're the boss? So, but in some instances, I said that my damn self, because I don't use that word lightly, but the bitch was acting like a bitch. Like, one-on-one, you cool as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
But when you out here and you're leading,
mm-hmm.
why you, but I'm like, is that a sense of like, you have to show that you're the dominant person because otherwise people won't respect you? Mm-hmm. Especially like some of the men in here who's been in here for a long time and, you know, they're 60 years old and you 30, but you got to tell them what to do. And they looking at you like, I ain't listening to no female. I don't listen to my wife. Yeah. So for you, like, do you feel that complex in your position?
A little bit. I see what Vasco's saying about, like, you know, women just carrying themselves instead of, you know, like, constantly explaining, oh, this is the position I'm in, and the, you know what I'm saying, bragging on that. It's just the way they walk and the mm-hmm. energy they exude that requires respect. So
I know not to step out of line when you come through.
I'm trying very hard, you know, to walk in that light, but at the same time, I'm only 28. You know what I'm saying? So I'm working on
and
it.
You wanna feel where men dominate.
Yeah. So it's probably like a 2% women probably in what I'm doing and what I'm talking about.
You know who I can appreciate? That's a woman, and I appreciate all women, but I love the way that she did this. So y'all remember Clubhouse was really hot.
Mm-hmm.
And I was in the Clubhouse room one time. One room I was in, and the guys were in there, and they were really disrespectful towards the women. Like, if a woman came in there and said something, they will be over-talking, da-da-da-da-da, mm-hmm. whatever. So I was in a room with a comedian by the name of Kiana Dancy. And it was a room full of comedians, and they were giving advice to someone. And Kiana was talking, and then another male comedian was trying to put his opinion in, cut her off, and was talking louder than her. And politely and sternly, Kiana said, excuse me, I'm talking. You ain't hear me talking? I'm talking.
Mm.
So when I get done, you can finish talking. And the room kind of went like... Then she went right back into what she was saying. She was like, so like I was telling you, da 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 da, and finished and said, now, Mr. So-and-so, you can go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Then he went right behind her and said, yeah, well, all I was going to say was da 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 da.
Now shit. All I was going to say. Yeah.
But I was like, she put him, not necessarily, I don't want to say put him in his place, but she so poetically and nicely and sternly said, listen, you're going to respect me just like you would Rodney Perry in this room, mm-hmm. just like you would Earthquake, just like you would Chris Spencer in this room. You're going to put the same respect on my name that you would to these other dudes, because, motherfucker, who the fuck are you? Right. I'm Keanu motherfucking
Dancy. You in my mm-hmm. fucking chat.
Yeah. So I would say to any woman in that, stand your ground. So if somebody raising their voice, I would like, oh, listen, you're up here. I need you to come on down here. Because I'm not raising my voice at you, so don't you raise your voice at me.
He was tight.
And then don't even go back and forth. Okay, well, listen, what you're trying to do is go back and forth, and I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to waste my mouth minutes with you. So whenever you're ready to have a conversation that involves two people or more, let me know.
Yeah. Yeah, me, I went immediately to the principal.
And then I'm gonna tell you, like I told my mama, when she, because she be talking about people, like, you know, talking crazy, not talking crazy, but like, you know, like people getting her and her feelings and stuff. Like when they worry, so I tell you, like I told her, like Lonnie Van Zant said, hey, look, hey, I apologize to you for letting you think it was okay for you to talk to me like that. But I want to let you know right now, today is the day it stops. So I apologize for letting that ride, but today is the day it stops. This is what we're gonna do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Set the tone.
Set the tone.
Any female bosses listening, set the tone, sis.
See, now what you just did.
That was too much. That was okay. Lot. It's okay. My bad.
Did you? Because bossy don't mean bitchy.
All right. Oh.
Hmm. Bossy doesn't mean bitchy. Right, it doesn't.
Right. I will say my best managers that I've ever worked for were minority women.
Mm-hmm.
The worst managers I ever worked for were men.
The worst managers I ever worked for were black women.
Really?
Yes.
No, I've had some awesome.
And that's sad to say. Well, not my last one was pretty. My last one was pretty decent. But before her, the black women who I worked for, they were, and it's not, and I'm not, and it's not their fault either, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's like I said earlier, they were in a pivotal position to where, like, damn, everybody in this bitch, like, how the fuck she get that? The white men are asking that question. The white women are asking that question. And then some niggas who working under you asking that same question. How the fuck she get that?
Mm-hmm.
Favoritism. She must be sleeping with so-and-so. Black women are dealing with that. And I understood it. But at the same time, she was the manager I'm talking about in particular. She was messy.
Yeah.
She was really messy. So I was on the side like, go ahead, black sister, prove to these people why you in this position. Then I was like, damn, black sister, you probably shouldn't be in this position.
Yeah, fucking it up. Fucking it all up.
Yeah. So.
Well, that's my woman want to know.
Well, shit. It.
Thank you.
Did that help at all?
That did help.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You going to go tomorrow and be like, yes, niggas.
No, look, like, stay on my ground.
Look, you motherfuckers.
Bossy don't mean bitchy. I'm going to remember that.
Y'all shit the fuck up today.
Bossy doesn't mean bitchy. That was pretty good, huh? Mm-hmm. Put that on the shirt.
I might
shit.
And I ain't breaking you off now.
I don't want nothing. I don't need that $15. Listen, we are the dignified delinquents.
One of them digs he was talking about that's supposed to get me in a car crying.
No. What? Well, how was that a dig? How was that a dig? You said your shirt's for 22. 20.
Bossy does not mean bitchy.
Vasco!
I was gonna say, why the music so low, man? Hey, man, it's your boy, Sco. Go ahead and follow me. Everything. IAM.VSJ. While you're on the tube, might as well go ahead and type in IAM.VSJ. Go ahead and watch that latest video. Leave a little like. And then go to the gram and blow that feed up, bruh. I'm gonna return the love. I'm telling you. For the other people who got it, who gave me some love, ask them. I gave them love back. So come fuck with your boy.
Somebody said he was a spirit animal. He ain't heard back from him until 2 months later.
But he heard back. I told him when I finally do get to doing it.
Oh, it's coming.
Oh, yeah. I'm finna be all there. You got my attention. So go ahead and fuck with
my dog
boy
in person.
Later.
Nah, yeah.
Come to the live show.
Come to the live show, G-Shit.
Oh, Nessa! So you can. Yeah, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, Nessa_Mufasa. Facebook, Nessa Ness. Go ahead and subscribe to us right now, Jerry.
Yo, it's your boy Jared the Great, your favorite. And listen, we are the Dignified Delinquents, man. Shout out to everybody who bought them live tickets, man. We sold that damn thing out. It's sold out, baby. Listen, follow me on all platforms at Jerry the Great. That's Jerry, T-H-A Great. Follow us. When I say us, I spit a little bit. I'm sorry. At the Dignified Delinquents on all platforms. TikTok is Dig. Defy.delinquents. On Twitter is dig.delinquents. We are the Defy Delinquents, and guess what? We out.